Hello, everybody. Are you sufficiently hyped for today? What's today?
This Thursday. Is
December.
Thursday.
Thursday.
You know that absolutely was being rhetorical, Thursday. Right? No Damiani sarcasm doesn't come through? Okay, fine.
Rhetorical,
you know
what? Thursday.
We're doing a clean opening for Bloodworth right now. How's it going, everybody? Welcome to the Damiani. Easy...
It's Thursday.
Bloodworth is interrupting me again. This is not nice. Very BM. But yes, Thursday, the Game Awards. Easy Ally is here. The crew is here. How's it going?
The Definitive Gamers.
Yeah, we're the Definitive Gamers.
Yeah, we are.
In fact, it lists us as that on the judges
sorry,
page.
Sorry, Don.
Hey, Don's working on my review at least.
Don,
nice.
Oh, all right, is that a
Don is a pizza flipper. He's a Definitive pizza flipper, so that's an honorary title.
He's with us.
Getting the esports stuff out of the way first. Nice.
Oh, is it live? Are you watching?
I am seeing a stream.
All right, let me refresh. Let me refresh real quick.
Twitch?
Oh, I think it loaded a video.
Oh yeah,
that's an ad.
Jones.
Mine just says
Jones,
it starts.
But
Jones
is
giving us
thing.
Ads.
Crushing to all these.
How do I
fans,
disable
sorry.
This stupid?
All right, we have 12 minutes. 11 minutes now. Who is the Smash Brothers character tonight? Who do you
Smash Bros?
What do we want? Unrealistic. Picks a realistic.
Whatever
picks.
I want. What should happen? Like what is the best time? I want the best timeline right now. What is the best timeline?
I always want Sora. I think Sora would be the most universal happiness.
Yeah,
Sora.
Dude. Yeah, Jonesy.
I think Sora coming in would just be like a rainbow that would just, you know.
Are you just saying that to appease Brad?
It would end in the end of 2020.
Dude, Hubert would be pleased also, and dude. You would be pleased, Damiani.
I mean, I would, but Sora. Jones would really picking pleased. Sora over other. I'm surprised, Jones.
Sora above
what if
all
it's,
else.
Yeah.
What if it's Baby Yoda?
Are we allowed to call Baby Yoda by
Psycho
another name
Mantis.
Yet?
I don't know.
Soon?
Is it too soon to say
I think
Baby
it might be
Yoda?
Is it too soon?
Through season two, soon. It's Baby Yoda.
I think we wait till season two is out, and then we can say Baby Yoda's name.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Oh, sure.
Okay.
Even just saying Baby Yoda's been named is a dangerous
point. We've already done
it. No, we said, like are you still allowed to call it that?
Okay.
And
when,
I can't say anything
when,
more.
When Minecraft... was added to Smash, it was like, oh, how's that gonna work? Whereas like Sora's just he's so Smash ready. You know, like he's
perfect.
Just I just think the combat just really fits.
That's a funny sentence.
He's ready to go.
Smash ready.
Smash ready. Stay.
memes aside though, Chrono, just do it. I'm not even kidding. That's the go to, the ultimate win.
Can you imagine
Chrono and everybody
Brad, that is always who my mind goes to anytime somebody says Smash characters.
The ultimate win. That'd be it. You're done.
Can all of you imagine them doing like a Chrono awesome. Video, like in that art style, like fully animated?
That would be sweet.
That's it. Like, you peaked. But I guess it would be all downhill from there.
Somebody, I just saw this as people were guessing Smash characters, but I actually do think Scorpion would be really, really fun.
That would be cool.
Like, I think it's just his kit would work really well in Smash, like the teleport and, of course, the spear and all that stuff. And like just Kirby in a scorpion mask is really great to me.
Yes.
Yeah.
Breathing
Kirby,
fire. Or something.
Get over here.
Oh my God, Kirby breathing fire would be amazing. Yeah. Yes. obviously, Kiryu would be good.
Mm-hmm.
Representation.
Oh, yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Do you
that
think
seems unlikely based on the
yeah? I was gonna say,
comments, but
yeah. What do you think about that now? That's not gonna happen. Any other guesses or wishes?
Ori.
Ori?
Master Chief.
Ori, okay. Ori.
Master Chief.
You know, Blood, what would piss me off about Ori is I think Ori would be awesome, and I would get mad at people complaining about it. You wasted a slot on this?
I can see that, Ben. I can totally see it.
I feel like that's going to happen so no much. Matter what.
Right.
Ori, maybe. Snooze.
It could be Goku, and people would be like, ooh, you ruined Smash Brothers.
Astrobot could be fun.
Oh, if you think they're going to give a Sony pick, Kratos time? Kratos Fortnite?
Already
Kratos
Fortnite,
Smash?
Dude, that'd be pretty wild
Kratos and Smash?
Yeah.
What if it's a Fortnite trailer, but then Kratos jumps through a portal and it ends up in Smash Brothers? That's how they do the reveal.
I think Ratchet and Clank would be the
Smash
best Sony
Fortnite.
One, though. If I were going to pick anyone from Sony, like Ratchet and Clank would be such a
Got
good
to.
Fit.
Yeah. Got to. Good call, Blood.
Listen,
because Minecraft is technically Xbox, you know, technically Microsoft at least.
I'm not just saying this just because it's me, but Monster Hunter does make sense.
Yeah.
Especially like right now with Rise on the Horizon.
It sure does.
And it already having some representation within the game.
Absolutely.
What would Monster Hunter Smash be? Some like Rathalos comes out.
Yeah, like that. I like where you're going with that. I think that would be good. Or you could just do like in your final Smash, you use every weapon.
Every weapon.
And it's like, you just do like an iconic move from each of the weapons. That would be neat.
Oh my god.
But what about like some like Palico's like cooking up a meal or something like that?
Oh my god. Yeah, yeah, yeah. That could be from great. Yeah, you do.
Or it could
what about
be
Dante.
That's too Dante's obvious at this
one.
Point.
Dante's a real good
that's
one.
Too, but that's too pedestrian.
Well, Dante and Virgil.
Both? Now you got my attention.
They probably would do something like that, considering the past
If
few...
they made Virgil like an echo of Dante, I'd actually be really pissed.
Well, no, what if it's like one... If it's like they come in together.
No, they're,
like
they're
like two Marvel separate characters. Capcom. You like tag them out or something.
They have to be separate. It would most likely, as Ben was saying, it most likely be either an Echo or just like another one of the character skin, you know, colors. Yeah.
They will add Dante's
limited slots.
Virgil and Dante would be like jump up and down, exciting though. That'd be so sick.
Virgil will be a Mii costume.
Watch it be Dante, but it's just DMC Dante, and there is no option to change the costume at all.
I'd be into it just for the meltdown.
What would the taunts be?
Pizza.
It would be like him making fun of the white hair like he does in the game.
For DMC Dante? Yeah, he'd just be like saying fuck you over and over or something like that.
Fuck!
Yeah.
Oh, that video is so good, dude.
Nemesis. Yeah.
For Monster Hunter, I guess.
Yeah, are there any Capcom characters in Smash?
Yeah, there's Ryu,
Mega Man, Ken. So quite a few.
Yeah.
Some of them Resident Evil would be...
There's room for more.
Yeah, yeah. There's room.
What about Leon? Frank West?
Frank West?
He's no. Like sick.
He's sick, but he's like dead,
could
man.
Be all right,
dumb, maybe he's an assist trophy.
Zombie
Have
Frank.
You ever seen Frank West's moveset in MVC? It's pretty fun.
Oh, yeah.
Well,
wow.
Besides Smash Brothers, there's probably going to be some other stuff tonight.
Dragon Age.
Of course.
Confirmed. Dragon Age.
They said, please be excited. You know,
they did? God.
They did it.
No, they basically just said, you know, tune in for more Dragon Age, whatever that screenshot or whatever that ends up being. Like, you know,
yeah, you're going to show us
nice,
the game, actually.
A nice slow zoom on a screenshot.
Weird Disco Elysium thing, maybe? Because Jeff tweeted out their website.
A sequel would be mind-blowing, Ian.
Is the console ports out? It could be the console ports.
Yeah.
I thought they were... There's someone using a table saw directly.
The console ports are not out.
Okay, yeah. They're not out?
Yeah.
Dude,
yeah.
DLC...
It's just that sucks.
A DLC would be awesome.
That's probably it, then.
Oh. We didn't talk about this beforehand, but if they drop... if they drop a Netflix game trailer, do I need to like kill anything so we don't get nuked into the ground?
Or do we want to risk it? We'll just go with it.
Okay.
Like, we'll just, yeah.
It is what it is. We're getting that Uncharted trailer, so
whatever happens, happens. We'll just have to figure it out after the fact.
Love it, dude.
If we vanish after the trailer,
Bloodworth, 10 out of 10.
If we go to federal prison after, you know, we're sorry, chat.
Yeah.
You ready for Mark Wahlberg Sully humor?
Oh my god.
Listen, Nathan. You gotta go up that cliff.
Dude, I'm really excited for that, Jones.
Wait, is that real?
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Because Wahlberg wanted to be Nathan Drake for a long time. It's like Kenneth Branagh and Thor. Like, he lived long enough to see the Thor movie, but then was too old to play Thor. So he was like, all right, just direct it then.
I have no idea how to gauge my hype for this. Like, my hype calibration is all off. Like,
it's totally off. Yeah.
Well, we're getting Silent Hill. We're getting Elden Ring. We're getting Dragon's Dogma 2. Mm-hmm. We're getting Dragon Age.
Shadow.
We're getting everyone in Smash.
Well, I just want a village demo.
We're yeah, demos would be full great games. Right now. Yeah,
full game village.
Oh, Shadow Drop, chill out. We could Shadow Drop the demo 2. Now because the new the consoles are out. Yes, yep. Uber.
I'm ready to download it immediately.
Oh my gosh, yes, Uber.
Yeah,
I will leave the call.
Kojima's gonna be on here for sure.
Yeah. Leave the call.
Aaron Greenberg from Xbox said, don't.
Yeah, I was going to bring that
we'll
up.
We'll have some stuff in it, but he was like, don't get excited. He's like, I'm seeing some people speculate stuff out there, and no. And
that's
it was
a double blind.
Telltale Games announced Wolf Among Us 2 last year, I think, and they were like, we're not going to do anything.
Yeah,
and there was something else. Oh, I just think Halo Infinite coming out was a very telling sign of them having their big update mm-hmm. recently. It's just like, don't expect to look at the game at the Game Awards this year.
They might actually be able to show a little bit of it. It probably wouldn't be that much.
Road, thank you.
Take a
Silk
look.
Song releasing Christmas Eve.
Yeah, because they said back at the beginning of this year, Nintendo said it was a 2020 game, a 2020 release. We're still in 2020.
Remember when No More Heroes was made fun of?
I know.
Releasing in 2020 and then everything happened.
I think Bossman has that on his fantasy draft, so I hope it doesn't come out this year.
You should be seeing a countdown right now on the Twitch
yep.
video. Okay, good.
404.
Nice.
2, 1, 0.
Yeah, I'm right there.
We're
with
synced.
You.
Nice. Yep.
Nobody do synced nothing.
Don't do
I think
anything.
Ideally.
Oh, do they have any stupid add-ons this year that I want to disable?
When I moused off of it, it went away, so I don't know.
Yeah, I'm not seeing anything at the moment.
What about Silksong, Ben?
All right.
Ideally, not only do they shadow drop it, but they say, hey, Easy Allies, we've already written and edited the review for you. Here you go.
What? Nice. I don't want that.
review script provided by
Yeah, review script.
Called Integrity, Bloodworth.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Let me take care of that maybe now, actually. We're not Nitro subscribed, are we?
Nitro!
So we don't see ads.
Wait, no, we should be. I think we have a recurring...
Actually, yeah, that's right. I don't see ads whenever I watch other channels. I don't know if it's whatever, but I haven't seen ads.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure we get receipts on that every month, so I think we're good.
Ben, I've often wondered that whenever I've like missed an embargo by like a day or two, it was like, what if when I finish the script, I hand the script through time to myself 2 days ago, would I trust myself?
No yeah,
to like captioning. Read the script and be like, I don't know. Let me finish the game and then I'll
just turned off some captions.
Hoping for a Hellblade update. It's been a while.
Ooh. Yeah.
It has been a while.
It's been a while.
Mm-hmm. Time.
Been a
what
while.
What is Joseph Ferris going to announce?
He's going to say, fuck the Emmys.
Mm.
Ah.
It's about time.
And the Grammys. And fuck the he's going to go for the EGOT.
The FIGOT.
The FIGOT. Wait, nope. that's rough territory.
Your bingo card.
But yeah, Brandon, like, that the handing out the script
ceremony
thing.
Which award ceremony will he attack?
I sent my twin mirror script to Huber because he finished it the same night I did. And yeah, it was fun to get his feedback.
Yep.
I want him to say, like, fuck Easy A Goaty or something. just really target us.
I saw that question in
Everyone's
chat.
Confused.
0% chance of 16 chat. They already said there will not be another update for that game.
Not until next year.
Next year.
What about Melody of Memory DLC?
Don't think that's happening.
What do you want for DLC from that game, Huber?
The songs backwards.
Yep. Trap remixes of every song.
Melody of Memory DLC, we will make you feel the exact same way you did when you originally played Kingdom Hearts. You're just
exactly.
buying feelings.
Well,
for real, last minute things, God of War Ragnarok and Last of Us Factions, please.
Oh, yep.
Factions seems much more likely of the two. Yeah,
that's a good
Elden
one.
Elden Ring, though. It's time to see Elden Ring.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, of course.
I think it's time to see Elden Ring. It's time for Bayonetta 3 to be out.
Oh, I thought you said Metal Gear 3. I was like, yeah, I'll see that.
So, real quick, yeah, the Blood and Ian will know that was like a recurring thing when we were talking about the year in review. And every month was pretty much an update. Everyone asked Kamiya about Bayonetta 3 updates. He's like, it's still progressing.
Yeah.
The biggest F you to everybody would be, it just releases today. It's like, he gets
Switch,
on screen and says,
installed.
Stop asking me.
If that's how he wants to troll me, I'm sure. All for it.
I really want a Resident Evil 8 demo today. That would be
it's
so hard.
That would be amazing.
All
dude.
I want, dude.
I mean, I want to see Elden Ring, and I want to see, like, if Silent Hill rumors are true, that would be amazing, but I'm not holding my breath.
Hold it, Ian. It's going to happen.
Hold it.
Yeah, hold it.
Just hold it, baby.
14 seconds.
Yeah, I'm going to start bringing the volume up here to audible levels in just a second.
Breath of the Wild sequel, baby. Show it. Don't be cowards, Nintendo. Now's the time.
All right, Chad, I'm going to need you to help me with the next.
May contain content.
Let me know if the game is too loud or we're too loud.
Asterisk Joseph Ferris.
Yeah.
Graphic violence.
I don't hear anything.
It's true of everything on the internet.
I don't hear anything.
There's no... Okay, here we go.
There it is.
No, geez, now I hear it.
Speaking of men here, coming to you live from Los Angeles, California. Welcome to the Game Awards pre-show. And please allow me to be the first to thank you for setting down Cyberpunk for a few hours.
Slightly unsynced.
As you can probably tell, the Game Awards are going to look a little different this year. Our venue may be smaller,
first and only mention
but the
of
show
Cyberpunk
itself
tonight.
Is as gigantic as ever. The awards and world premieres won't be changing, except sure. I guess the only people clapping will be me and probably a few crew members. Going remote this year will bring us musical performances from London and Tokyo. And one positive of tonight's mostly digital gathering is we'll get to see more faces in the talented teams behind this year's outstanding
Zoom
games.
Zoom call.
As for us here in the pre-show, we'll be spending the remaining minutes before the Game Awards kick off with brand new trailers, mercifully brief integrated
hype.
Marketing, and Lynn will be performing a song from Persona 5 Strikers. And best of all,
integrated marketing.
The big
yes!
reason we're all
Yo.
Here.
Let's go.
Our first category tonight is best score in
most
music.
People
better mute it.
Oh. It's a particularly strong contest this year with five
best
standout nominees
year.
That could
this
on their own
category.
Represent the
I'm
best
so intimidated.
Streets of Rage is not on this list.
Here
I'm
are the nominees
the
for best score.
No, they already had yeah,
you
know
sure.
the nominees.
You...
He wasn't there. They already had the nominees.
You were leaving the call.
Oh, Ori and the Will of the Wisps.
Bye.
And The Last of Us Part 2. And the winner is...
What is it?
Final Fantasy VII Remake.
Let's go, baby!
Yeah, baby.
Yes.
Yes.
Justice. He needs to win again.
I probably would have said that for any of those drops.
Yay. そしてファイナルファンタジー7の原曲を作ってくれた上松さんありがとうございました。大変感謝しております。そして、もう一度このゲームを音楽に注目しながらプレイしていただけると大変嬉しいです。ありがとうございました。
That's a Moogle.
No, the mouse.
As I said earlier, you'll be seeing
no, that's
a
Moogle.
Different world premieres throughout this pre-show, but strangely enough, we've decided to show you our most important one first. Here it is.
Okay.
What?
I doubt that.
World premiere.
Welcome what? To the Devolver Digital 2021
yep.
Game of the Year Award. No. Sponsored by Devolver Digital. And now, your host, Devolver Digital CEO, Nina Struthers.
Okay, shush
new,
it. So yeah, tonight we are here to celebrate this year's most memorable video games. Let's not overlook the unrelenting hype, not for this, but for next year's as-yet-to-be-released games coming at you hot from what many believe to be this industry's most ridiculously overrated publisher. While most of these games are months away from release, we at Devolver Digital are strong proponents of awards for awards' sake. And with that,
is
the nominees for the Devolver Digital 2021 Game of the Year are
Shadow Warrior 3 by Flying Wild Hog, Olia by Skeleton Crew Studio, Card Shark by Nero, Weird West by Wolfeye.
Yeah, Card Shark, dude.
Boomerang
let's go Card
X
Shark.
By Dang.
I haven't heard about this one.
And the winner is
Dang.
Loop Hero by developer Four Quarters.
It wasn't a nominee.
Wasn't even in the nominee.
Crap.
We're all pissed.
Four Quarters couldn't be here with us this evening because it was unannounced pissed. Until well, just now, really. Let's have a look at Loop Hero.
Your world has been cast into a dark spiral.
What a setup.
Place enchanted cards along a harrowing.
No, that's like Ultimate.
Yeah.
Monsters, build cathedrals, and remember your world.
I wonder how long the old old games are then. It's kind of fun to go back to those.
Level up your hero, expand your camp, customize your card deck, and uncover secrets.
Did I make this game?
Break the slime wall and save your world. Loop Hero, coming in 2021.
Thank you.
Oh, yo, funny thing is, if the game of 2021 doesn't come out.
Whatever.
Huber, if you could bump your audio up, if you have a way.
Every year, the Game credits. Awards do our best to highlight new games from all sorts of developers, from AAA big shots like Devolver,
really
to smaller independent
thing.
Studios.
Yeah, me too.
Our next world premiere is the debut of a new game from Awaseb, a young studio started in New Caledonia. Enjoy.
Kingdom Hearts?
Yeah, it does look like
I know.
It looks, yeah.
Moana, let's go.
Whoa. Whoa, yeah, it's a little scary.
Yeah.
That is a brave girl.
Yeah.
Oh. I did not see this coming.
It's like, great.
Uh-oh. A lot of things going on here.
Yeah. Become the crab. Whoa.
Yeah.
Chia.
Oh, and the flower is like
very
Mario.
Very cool.
Hat.
Yeah, the cappy.
Yeah.
Strong bonds going on. You have my interest.
It's Breath of the Wild, Mario Odyssey, Last of Us guitar.
This
mechanics.
Next award category is for one game. Of gaming's most popular genres, action adventure.
Nice.
The breadth of what is considered an action adventure game also leads to this regularly being one of our most competitive categories.
Weird thing to put in the pre-show.
Incidentally, for the past 3 years, the Game Award winner for action
genre.
Adventure has gone
yes,
on to
is.
Win Game
right.
of the Year. So. This is a
but
good
it's also like where a lot of the
Here
biggest
are the
games
nominees
are, so.
For
well,
best
no,
action adventure
such
game.
A weird
Assassin's
what?
Creed Valhalla.
Everything qualifies.
Ghost
it's
of
the only
Tsushima.
Genre slash genre.
Marvel's Spider-Man, Miles Morales. Ori
and
the Will of the Wisps.
Partly because adventure means something
Star
totally
Wars Jedi Fallen Order.
Industry, so.
And The Last of Us
Ooh,
Part
like,
2.
This is
one
intense.
Of these games
the
is not like the
is
others.
This is Tsushima versus Last of Us. Tsushima versus
Probably.
Last of Us, man.
The Last of Us Part 2.
Happen.
There it is.
Wow, we won.
It begins.
Well, awesome. It's now The Last of Us versus Hades.
Game Award for choosing us as the best action adventure game. On behalf of the directors, which is myself, Anthony Newman, and Neil Druckmann, we want to thank the entire team
All
at Naughty Dog
Jeff,
for their heart
the
and
idea
souls
of
into
giving
this game.
Awards,
it's really
it's
their talent
the
that
show
immerses you in that world and
all.
Really makes you feel like you're on this journey with Ellie.
Doesn't make any sense.
We want to thank Evan Wells, our president. Also, everyone
Joe
at Sony and our
yet.
Partners for really helping us put this game together and get out the door. And especially to our fans who supported us and really helped make this game something special. You guys make it worth it, so thank you again.
Congratulations once more to The Last of Us Part 2. We have many more awards coming up in the pre-show, but first, here's another trailer.
Kind of like what defines a pre-show.
Hey everyone, I'm Connie. I'm
like,
the CEO and creative director
For
of my
years,
games
Jeff's
company
pre-shows
called
have just been
and
the
Beautiful
show.
World.
Just smaller, and
it
Jeff's
was
not in it.
Such an honor
yeah.
to be nominated for the games
oh, game?
For impact category at last year's The Game Awards for our most important project today called Sea of Solitude. I'm very happy to announce that Sea of Solitude will be coming to Nintendo Switch this winter.
Nice.
But
nice.
It's not just a port. We fully reworked the entire game. We're calling it the Director's Cut. because it's a version that truly represents what I wanted to convey about the topics that are especially important in today's difficult times. We can't wait to share it with you. Until then, stay safe, enjoy the Game Awards, and see you soon.
Nice.
Oh.
This is the trailer for it.
My monsters. The path is full of stone. You know them too, don't you? The river comforts me no more. They're waiting for us to capsize. A stranger shore. To drown. Cold wind blows. We'll face them. We'll chase them across the sea of solitude.
The first strike-worthy thing.
We'll set sail, and we won't stop until we reach safe harbor.
I think this is new VO. They got to get different voices.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh,
really?
Yeah, I mean, I'm very curious when she says it's not a port. Yeah, there it is.
Yeah, new voice.
New script. Huh.
Interesting.
We've had some great world premieres already, but we recognize there may be some fans of elegant, shadow-based puzzle games who feel left out. Don't worry. We've got something for you, too.
Uh-huh.
From Focus Home Interactive, here is Shady Part of Me.
I like all
Shady Part of Me.
Okay.
There once was a girl who was trapped in the dark, with naught but her shadow
for
company.
I feel like I've seen this, but under
a journey to escape, she did embark, and her shadow followed distrustfully.
I like the little
girl found no hope in life, but despair. Her shadow smiled. With me, there is a way. Hand in hand, we break free from this nether. Step by step, we will rise together.
It's like Lost in Shadow meets Contrast.
Yeah.
Contrast,
huh? Now available.
Now available.
Yo!
Shadow drop.
Shadow drop.
Baby.
Shadow drop.
If you're just joining us now,
very
welcome.
Literally.
We're in the middle of what has turned out to be a jam-packed pre-show for the Game Awards. We've just premiered two trailers back-to-back. And now we'd like to take a moment to announce the winners of three awards. First is Best Family Game, a category that did a lot of heavy lifting this year throughout the months of what seems like endless lockdown. When pools closed and Chuck E. Cheese went bankrupt, Family Games were all there. The nominees are
Animal Crossing,
New Horizons, Crash Bandicoot 4, It's About Time, Fall Guys, Ultimate Knockout, Mario Kart Live, Home Circuit, Minecraft Dungeons, and Paper
Crash
Mario,
so
the Origami King. And the winner is Animal Crossing New Horizons.
Surprise.
Next, I have the honor of awarding Best Community Support.
Oh, sure.
It's like
this
Freeze Company.
This category debuted last year, and
weird,
it represents the games that
like
truly value their player base. Demonstrated through communication
and respect.
Don't
love that, Huber.
Here are the nominees. Apex Legends, Destiny 2, Fall Guys Ultimate Knockout, Fortnite, No Man's Sky, and Valorant.
Destiny won this last
And the winner
year,
is Fall Guys Ultimate Knockout.
Fall Guys, wow.
Finally, we get to acknowledge the winner for Best Debut Game.
Yeah.
This award goes to nominees that represent an independent studio's first ever release. It's an award for fresh perspectives, new ideas, and distinguished bravery. The nominees for Best Debut Game are
Distinguished Bravery.
Carrion, Mortal Shell,
Your
Phasmophobia, So Raji, an ancient epic. And Roki. And the winner is...
Roki Bloodworth.
Phasmophobia.
Phasmophobia,
yeah. Nice. Yeah. Yep. Yeah, good for them.
That's five trophies down, and the Game Awards haven't even officially started yet. As the handy countdown timer says, we are minutes away. So I'd like to take a moment to let you know about a few ways you can interact with tonight's big show. All night long, fans will be predicting the winners on Twitch using a special voting extension powered by Verizon 5G built
for gamers.
That's a
good game. Phasmophobia, definitely.
Lock in your picks throughout the night to see if you guess the right winner and whether you're watching on our official channel or from one of hundreds of co-streams. Mega Drops will be activated for Fortnite and Among Us. Over the last few days, fans have visited our at the Game Awards TikTok channel and voted on which The Last of Us Part 2 team they support.
Audio blip
Team
there,
Abby
huh?
or Team Ellie. The votes are in, and Team Ellie won the vote.
Oh, I think they were just in the
same. Thanks
sink.
For your votes, and be sure to follow us on TikTok if you haven't yet to catch all
Abby,
our great games.
Looks like it's
Abby Anderson.
We pulled Reddit's r/gaming community to see what their pick is for 2020's Game of the Year. And the winner is Ghost of Tsushima.
Yeah, that was super
as
weird.
What the hell?
That was
super
weird.
Obviously, we won't learn that until the end of the night. For now, we're about
what
to take
do each
a
of
super
them have?
Short break. But coming up on the other side, we've got winners for each of our esports awards, a Persona 5 Strikers performance, and of course, more world premieres.
I cannot wait for this Persona 5 performance.
Hey, thanks, Sydney.
Same.
Listen, it's hard for me to believe
best thing
that
to look forward to right now.
27 years ago. That my brother Robin and I watched players venture into the Ages of Mist for the first time. Anyway, today I am so excited to start a new chapter of Mist with the release of an entirely reconstructed VR version that's available now on the Oculus Quest platform. We've got something special for anyone who purchases Mist.
So
we'll unlock a Mist-themed Oculus
only VR. It came out
I'm
today.
I'm so thrilled for you to experience Mist
VR. I got
VR,
three emails about
thank
this.
You so much.
You made it, actually.
Yeah. I don't have a Quest, but...
But it's the same map as the original.
I mean, they had to change it to work in, three, or in VR, but... They're redoing it? Sort of. Shadow Marva. What a brief glance.
Very brief.
Welcome back to the Game Awards pre-show. For the first time ever, I get to introduce a musical performance right here in the pre-show. And I'm not sure there could be anything better to jump off with. Performing Last Surprise from the Persona 5 Strikers soundtrack from Tokyo, Japan, here is Lin featuring the Persona Band.
Probably going to be better than the main show.
I was going to say, why is this the pre-show?
Game Awards. Seriously. Are you ready?
Mm-hmm.
Yes.
Yeah. So jolly. I want to be in this band. New life goal.
I'll become a Japanese studio musician.
I think it's possible.
I think it's possible.
I think it's possible. Show me got that clue. How about this we go? Don't you know? No more. And as a look to the home.
Yeah, it's a great live version.
Oh, I want that org.
Yeah, I want a recording of this. This is a really good version.
Well, it sounds like it's in record. I don't know if it'd be exactly this.
Yeah.
February 2021.
Turn it up.
Why just a vehicle second arrow with blue sky by the lightning that goes through the
world? Yeah, so like this we wouldn't need, but like if we get like some random pop song performance, mm-hmm.
You never see it coming. The bass is coming through so well.
I just have to do a picture-in-picture some gameplay.
I mean, in a way, like, this kind of thing benefits from not having to be live at the show. Because they got everything set up
doing
the way
a
it should
sick
sound.
Solo on a
right.
Phone.
Yeah. So many times a venue just, like, won't be in tune with an act or something. It'll sound good in person, but it'll sound terrible on screen, you know?
That was such a crisp rendition of that song. Mm-hmm.
Thank you. Remix.
At this year's TGS, Square Enix officially announced an update to 2010's Nier Replicant, the prequel to Nier Automata. The actual title of this remake was, of course, another sick joke from director Yoko Taro.
Sick
but
joke.
The Game Awards pre-show will never turn down a challenge. Tonight, I am both happy and unafraid to introduce the gameplay debut for Nier Replicant version 1.22474487139...
She hates him right now.
That's
sick joke.
You make me read this out loud.
Tablet program?
Yeah, your book.
That's your book.
Oh, cool. Instead of the bot, you have a book?
Yeah, because yeah. You
it's a
absorb
yeah.
Words mm-hmm. Or letters. To...
It's music, dude.
It's the best.
Yeah, it's really bullet hell.
Oh, yeah.
I haven't seen this at all.
Ooh, these guys look way better.
Yes.
Yeah. You'd be the proper main character now.
Cool.
Brother Nier.
Brother Nier. Papa Nier's dead.
It's been a special night already.
Yo, PC
and now
day
I get
one,
to
baby.
Share with you another Game Awards first. The world premiere of a new band. You heard me correctly.
Whoa.
They're playing their debut single, what? Follow Unfollow. Please welcome, for the first time
I got
ever,
an email about this.
OFK.
Oh.
Is it falling apart? Was
oh.
It already broken? Am I back at the start?
I want to react.
My friend Teddy is his company. All I've ever known is that Palm Tree is the code name.
Got it.
But I read the email, so after the performance is done, the embargo is right. Up, and I can answer that question.
Yeah, this is about being a man.
Yeah.
Interactive series.
So it's like an interactive behind the scenes making
Tonight's
the band.
About celebrating
kind of
all of 2020's
thing,
best in the
nice.
World of
Wait,
gaming.
Is it a game?
And that would be impossible
kind of, yeah.
without honoring
I think
esports
it's a game.
Best talent, who despite everything
they called it an
thrived
interactive
and
series,
continued
so
to entertain and inspire.
Oh, got it.
Of the 30 different Game Awards categories, 5 are esports awards. We're about to announce each winner, but I may need to call in some help to get through them all. We'll see. Here we go. For best esports game, the nominees are Call of Duty, Modern Warfare, Counter-Strike,
now.
Global Offensive, Fortnite, League of Legends, and Valorant. And the winner is League of Legends.
That one of the smart things they did with these
For
categories
best esports
is they
coach, the
us.
Nominees are
they had different people
Presti,
vote on these categories.
Grabs, Rambo, Zeffa, and Zonic. And the winner is Zonic. For best esports event, the nominees are Blast Premier Spring 2020 European Finals, Call of Duty League Championship 2020, IEM Katowice 2020, League of Legends World Championship 2020, and Overwatch League Grand Finals 2020. And the winner is League of Legends World Championship 2020.
League.
For best esports host,
Pretty popular
the nominees
game.
Are Dash,
yeah, a little bit.
Golden Boy, Machine, Shiver, and Shox. And the winner is Shox. For best esports team, the nominees are Dallas
it's
Empire.
It's really a golf clap.
Damn One Gaming.
Mm-hmm.
It ends
golf clap
San Francisco Shox.
Drops off.
And Team
to make
sense.
It a real video gaming
the
event, they need to add like one dude who's always
G2
just like,
G2 Esports. Congratulations to all of the winners.
Everyone's like, shut up, dude.
And now to it's announce awesome. The winner of Best Esports Athlete, here's the host of ESPN's First Take and the new ESPN Plus show, Stephen A's World, Stephen A. Smith.
They have Stephen A. Smith on this? This is amazing.
Is this the stay off the damn happen? Weed guy?
Athletic sports? That's not the point. They're doing their thing.
A better mic.
When every major sports league in the nation shut down, esports
this is
just
to stay off the damn
going.
Weed guy.
That echo,
With that being
man.
Said, I'll say this much: all of the esports athletes nominated are, without question, more determined, more tenacious, and definitely win more than anybody on the Dallas Cowboys.
He's got the Dallas
Cowboys.
Got that? Yeah.
Kenyon, Shotzi,
oh my God.
Zai
oh,
Wu.
That's great.
And the winner is...
The counter just went away.
Showmaker.
Over time.
일단 이런 상을 주신 거에 대해서 되게 영광스럽고 감사하게 생각하고 뭐 팬분들의 응원이나
His echoes.
선수들, 감독, 코치님 전부 다 노력해서
And the dog in the background.
항상 열심히 하면서 살겠습니다. 감사합니다.
You can definitely sense it, right? The Game Awards are about to begin. Stephen A. Smith just handed out the final award of the pre-show. And now it's time for one last premiere before the main show Ooh. Begins. And it's got something we could all use a little more of.
No.
Dragons fighting dragons.
Stephen A. Smith has a history
Here's
of hating
Sentry,
on the Cowboys.
Age
it's
of
amazing.
Ashes.
World premiere.
I completely forgot to take notes through that whole pre-show.
I thought Ian, that was like
I got it.
The
trip.
Oh,
that
cool.
Was me.
Yo, this looks
yeah,
like hands
like
are
good.
Dragons.
It's good.
It does, yeah. Layer 2 would be
yeah.
amazing.
Whoa, yeah.
yeah.
Layer 2, come on.
Oh my God.
It shouldn't be called Layer 2, it should be called Layer 1 again.
Dude,
this is a
just,
lot.
Just
like,
freaking
Panzer Dragoon.
Yeah, yeah this is just straight up this Panzer Dragoon.
Looks kind of cool,
epic
though.
Ass music.
Yeah, it looks sick.
PS3 who? Whoa.
Multiplayer.
Ooh. Squad up. Ride with me.
I'll ride out with you, dude.
Dragons?
I want to rule the skies.
Yeah.
Layer 2, dude. Sick.
February.
February.
Sign up now. Yeah.
Intrigued.
Yeah, I want to play. I want to play.
Let's run.
And with that, it means I'm about to sign off and hand it over to Jeff. Look forward to performances from Eddie Vedder and the London Philharmonic Orchestra.
We'll be playing
the traditional Game of the Year medley, as well as the special surprises. There will be world premieres from Fall Guys, Dragon Age, Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, Among Us, huge surprises, little surprises, and of course, awards for the greatest games of 2020. This is Sydney Goodman signing off. The Game Awards start
surprises?
Right now.
Yeah,
man.
Or as Cyberpunk would call them, default surprises.
Where's my warm porridge at?
Dude,
Ether.
It's like Gilly some Bucks. Intense, like, Gilly music.
Like, is this a new Remedy Games?
Or sneakers.
Hello, everyone. Yeah.
Those shoes showed up first,
to
dude.
The Game Awards 2020. We
shoes
are so
first.
Happy to have you joining us tonight.
Kicks.
You know,
I love his
this
mark.
Year,
nice.
Of course, will be
for
a little
second,
bit different.
Were the galaxy,
it's been a tough year
shoes.
For everyone, I know. And normally, with the holiday season, we'd all be gathering with our friends and family. And I know that can't happen for all of us. But tonight, we can gather here and connect around games, something that we all love. Games connect us. And I'm here in Los Angeles, and whether you're watching
Bonds,
live right now Bonds. In China early Bonds in the morning, in Europe, America, my native Canada, wherever you are, even in
Woo!
India this year, all over the globe, we are coming together tonight
say
to celebrate our love of video
true.
Games.
He's
now,
super
everyone safe tonight.
I should have made
a joining us live
Look at those
Zoom
corpos
from all over the
zippers,
world. You can see them there. Hi, everybody. They're all joining us from their homes and their studios.
Hi.
China, Europe, Los Angeles, far and
I
wide.
See Reggie.
And we will have all these guys joining us
yeah, are there any spoilers
tonight as we
here?
Get through all the awards live in the show. We're going to be joined
Miyazaki
also by some very special guests. Keanu Reeves, Gal Gadot, Brie Larson, Tom Holland, Christopher Nolan, John David Washington, the Swedish Chef,
cannot
Reggie
wait for that.
Chris Nolan is going to be
also
can't wait for
a
it.
Very special performance.
It's going to be weird.
Pearl Jam. He will be in Seattle
be
and the London
stadium,
Philharmonic
what?
Orchestra from Abbey Road Studios in London,
which will be weirder.
Conducted by
James
Lauren Balfe. It is
going to
be an amazing show, and as
Nolan.
Always, we've got
Cameron's
the awards, we've got
pick.
First looks, we've got new
he?
Game announcements. All of the things that make the Game Awards special will be here. And what I love about this show is that the entire industry comes together tonight to celebrate games.
Just looking thinner.
Everyone is here. Or at least I thought everyone was here.
Everyone's...
It does sound
oh,
like
Smash.
We're still expecting
we
someone else to arrive.
Smash Brothers.
Yep. It's gotta be, right?
Miyazaki.
It's gotta be. With that setup, it has to be.
Oh, baby.
Yep.
Here we
yeah.
go.
Yeah, here it is.
Oh
right off the bat.
Oh, my God. Oh, my God. It's too intense. Dude, high caliber fighter. Beating everyone.
Yeah.
Oh.
Oh, back to the story stuff.
Going back.
Yeah.
Build up.
Story stuff.
It's all coming full circle.
Does that mean time travel?
Goku.
Literally
Goku,
that time
let's go.
Thing.
Come here. Yeah,
that?
Goku.
The wing ball.
Someone frozen in time?
Someone with the blade.
That.
Oh.
Oh.
Oh shit!
Oh
shit!
Fuck yeah,
oh
dude!
God.
Oh my god!
Fuck
oh my
yeah.
god!
Oh my god!
Yes,
dude!
Fuck you!
Oh my god!
Alright,
alright!
Where's
the despair?
God! Oh shit! It's the Avatar thing, right here!
Wow! Yeah. Japanese, Japanese voice actor too.
Oh,
this is the best Game Awards ever.
Oh my god!
Oh, it looks so good.
Talk about reach! Oh my goodness.
Yeah, dude.
You think Sephiroth half just of the win by default?
Yeah. He just unmakes the level.
Oh, show me that final smash.
Oh shit! Dude, that's the airship?
Yes.
Oh my god! Is this Final Smash just like Advent Children?
Yes, dude, it's the one wing!
One wing!
Oh my god!
Oh my god!
Supernova!
Dude, get fucked up!
Oh my god! Okay, Nintendo.
Alright.
Oh my god.
Wow. First Luigi dies at this. This is pretty hype right here, man.
This is
pretty insane.
Holy shit!
Oh.
You can get all his sashes in it. That's canon.
So this is me actually gonna get more Final Fantasy music this time?
Hell yeah, more Final Fantasy music.
Where's...
Damn it, go away.
Yes.
Yep.
Just
fucking Advent Children. Yeah, this is just the end of Advent Children.
Yep.
Yeah.
Oh! Oh, what? Shit! What? What? Holy shit!
Oh, that's his final smash, probably.
Whoa, oh, dude, what? Yes! Coming up!
Oh, that's my god!
Yes.
Coming
up!
Oh, yes,
that's what
dude.
I was waiting for. Oh, all right, the fun is just getting started. Moment. But of course, this show is also about awards. And to present our first award, you probably know her as Captain Marvel. She's an Oscar-winning actor, a filmmaker, and a dedicated activist. And she's joining us now, live on Zoom. It's Brie Larson. Hey, Brie.
Hello. Tonight, I am honored to present the award for Best Performance. Among the nominees is an inclusive group of talented actors filling vastly different roles in games that are nothing alike. However, these artists are nominated tonight for what they share in common, a clear dedication to their craft and an extraordinary ability to bring humanity and empathy to their roles. Here are the nominees for Best Performance.
Best Performance.
The Khan deserves to suffer.
Stupid boy, you shall never reach the surface.
No, don't look. Dad! Dad!
Don't be a hero, Miles.
Okay, let's do this.
Let's go.
Can we just give them all winners?
And the Game Award
yeah,
goes
a good
to
lineup.
So good.
Yeah.
Laura Bailey as Abby, The Last of Us Part 2.
Yeah.
Whoa! I thought Ellie would take it for sure.
Nice.
Oh, wow. Wow. I was such a fan of the original Last of Us and of Troy and Ashley's performances within it. I fell in love with Joel and Ellie. So it is no surprise to me that Abby's role within this story has been met with such passionate responses. But to have been able to play such a fantastically challenging character who, through her story, enables the player to find forgiveness and empathy is something that I'll be eternally grateful for. Oh man, I told the team on the day that I finished filming that what I wanted more than anything was for my performance to give a performance that honored the impact that the original game had on me. So this award means so much. Thank you to Neil and to Hallie and the entire team for giving me the opportunity and for all of the support and the guidance along the way. To Patrick and Ian and Grace for everything you did, the story, and Abby would not have been as impactful without you by my side. To Troy, who
congratulations, from a friend, working together
in this industry. We've been allies, we've been enemies, and we've been everything in between. And every single time I work with you, I come away better for it. Thank you for always having my back. And to Ashley, who I love so much. I don't know what else to say other than I think you should probably be giving the speech right now. I think you're amazing, and your strength and your power and your vulnerability and your performance left me speechless. I love you. Marry me. To my husband, Travis, who spent countless hours just listening to me come to terms with what this game's journey has been. And to the fans, obviously, to everyone who voted, thank you for your support and for your love and for your passion and for allowing yourself to go on this journey with Abby and with me.
The fan one.
Thank you. I love you.
Journalists are fans too.
Congratulations, Laura. I think I heard iMessages coming in for people.
How many people on Zoom just turned off their phones?
It's so great to have everyone here celebrating an amazing year for games. All right, we are streaming on every platform tonight, including Twitch, where we have drops for Among Us and Fortnite, who both have world premieres coming up later in the show. And throughout the night, we will also be interactive on Twitch. You can predict who you think will win using a Twitch extension. First up, best ongoing game. So go and vote now. Lock in your prediction.
Shadow Mega Drop.
All right, well, even with everything going on, it's been one of those special years that sees the launch of new next-gen consoles. And with that, brings a whole new generation of games. Tonight, we are honored to have one team, a new team of veterans, reveal the very first details about their ambitious and exciting new project right here at the Game Awards. Enjoy.
Is this the Second Strike thing?
I love his turnaround.
Pretty much since the day I started, there's been a really clear player fantasy. I think the thing that makes it different from a lot of first-person games is it's not just about shooting.
Eco-sci-fi is a term that we use.
Future fiction, but from an ecological focus.
There's been this ecological disaster.
These corporations came in and they developed new technology, and on the surface, everything's pretty great.
We're still early in development, but we're really excited with where things are going.
We wanted to share a cinematic piece that helps set the tone for our world.
Another way too early announcement?
Yep. Oh no, the initiative, okay.
Is that their company or the game?
Yeah,
that's the company.
Yeah,
that's what I thought.
Ice Age.
I remember when everything changed.
Oh my god, if it's a Waterworld game.
The flood.
Yeah, it is.
The storms. Fires, people dying in the streets. The corporations gave us solutions. A better way.
I like this music.
Mega City 1, let's go.
And we welcome
it's too sunny for Mega
lives.
City 1.
Yeah, totally.
But the laws of nature aren't meant to be broken. We need to know what they're hiding.
It's a cruel, cruel world. Goodbye,
vocals are so weirdly mixed in this song.
What?
Wait a second.
Perfect Dark? Low.
Perfect
that Dark?
Logo.
It yeah. seems like it's Perfect Dark.
Chad. Was that the Perfect Dark logo? Yeah.
Agent Dark.
Holy shit. Holy shit. Whoa. Okay.
Yeah, dude.
Wow.
Man.
Damn, dude, that's not the tone I expected.
Oh man, oh.
Perfect Dark.
Okay, no Xbox surprises. Yeah, sure.
Dude, there you go. Perfect Dark from the initiative Xbox. Very excited to have that announced. All right, well, we're gonna go right into another game announcement for the first time right here at the Game Awards. Check it out.
Didn't we always say they were gonna do Perfect Dark initiative? We guessed that.
It was a rumor, but that trailer did a good job of disguising it until the end.
We are directly responsible for it. It would not have happened without us.
I believe it.
Uh-oh, the thing.
Yeah, dude.
Probably, yeah. Disturbing.
Who
could not foresee that kind of thing?
Whoa.
Whoa.
Oh.
Turtle Rock.
Oh, Turtle Rock, yeah. Sick. Back for Blood.
Yeah.
Oh.
Nice. Life, just not today. Feel your blood, there's hell to pay.
The confidence.
There's too many.
Stick together. We got a job to do.
Remember?
And no worm-ridden son of a bitch is gonna stop us.
What a line.
What are they gonna be called? So wormies? What are they gonna call them?
Yeah. Worms
Armageddon. Flithers? What are they gonna be called?
Oh.
I like all these companies that's just like, well, they're not gonna make Left
4
Dead. We
will.
Well, no, these are the guys that made Left
4
Dead.
They,
yeah.
They did make Left
4
Dead.
Yeah. Well, Valve isn't Left 4 Dead.
Yeah.
Tank. Yeah, Boomer and Tank.
Oh, man. All the faces on him.
This is my favorite hoodie.
A little club soda will take that right out.
Nemesis.
Watch out!
Yeah, it is like Nemesis.
Yeah,
first.
Yeah, first. That actually is kind of close to Perkins' design.
Yeah. Just way taller.
Pirate Birkin.
It has four in it, dude.
Yeah, it's so...
it's so funny.
The logo was a 4-2.
For Blood, and I'm now joined by Chris Ashton of Turtle Rock Studios. This is pretty exciting for all us Left 4 Dead fans. Of course, you guys are known for all the amazing work Left 4 Dead, and now you're building building on the legacy with this new zombie co-op shooter. What's new? What can you tell us about it, Chris?
Well, we wanted to do more and bigger, right? We wanted to have more playable characters, more missions, more story, but we also wanted to have a bigger variety of zombies to fight, right? But also we wanted to go bigger. So now we've got these 20-foot tall zombie monstrosities that are definitely gonna take, you know, the help of your friends in order to defeat.
All right, well, it's great to have this game announced, but it sounds like
internally they refer to it as
the prepared a little surprise for everyone watching,
maybe.
Right?
Oh, yeah, like movies are cool, but gameplay is king, right? So let's see some of that.
Yeah, okay, here we go. Yes. Here's the gameplay reveal of Back 4 Blood.
Yes.
Thanks, Chris.
It sounds like they turned on an air vacuum.
Yeah, there's something.
To keep the COVID away from them.
There's definitely a filter going on in that studio.
Here we go. Not what I call gameplay yet.
This is like the Dark Souls of Left 4 Dead games.
Ready?
Not one for speeches. So how about we just go kill some Rippers?
Nice pep talk.
Ah, damn.
That's exactly what I expected. Rippers? That's a good thing.
Oh, yeah. They are not messing around.
Watch out!
Oh, he looks so fun.
I got a bullet for you! And you!
Kind of tough to see your teammates. I wonder if it's like a pulse.
Yeah. Mechanic. I think it's because there's
like
no
the
HUD.
HUD is off. Because I shoot my teammates already in this game. Yeah.
I definitely do. It is well documented.
Oh, yeah. Look how good this dude is.
Sick.
It's funny that Valve can't like suit them.
The viscera in this is pretty sweet.
Yeah.
Oh, nice.
That's cool. Cool. But you're not safe.
Need to finish them off and fast.
It is cool to have such like three or four different heights of enemies.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Really.
Yeah, that weak spot's cool.
Please just die already.
Evangela, watch out.
Grabs you.
Oh, no. Shit.
I think this will be a fun video.
Oh, it'll be fun. It just looks so fun.
Mm-hmm.
Ooh. Why run into that?
I'm not sure.
June it's a good shot, again. But
that's pretty soon.
Yeah.
Start playing December 17th.
Yeah.
Oh, that's
next whoa. Week.
Can we stream that? I hope so.
That'd be depends, cool. But likely.
I hope so, dude. Yeah.
There cool, you go, cool. Back 4 Blood, June next year, Alpha next week. Crazy. All right, very exciting. Well, tonight we're celebrating games, and we've got awesome discounts on many of tonight's nominees with the Game Awards sale across Xbox, PlayStation, Nintendo eShop, Epic Game Store, and Steam. And we also have the Game Awards Festival, a chance to play upcoming games like Little Nightmares 2, and some of the games are also available instantly with GeForce Now. So make sure to check that out. You can stream on any device with no downloads on GeForce Now.
Yeah,
well, we also
cool.
have a lot of great stuff coming up. We'll have performances from the London Philharmonic Orchestra and Eddie Vedder. But right now, 2 years ago, we announced at the Game Awards Scavengers from Midwinter Entertainment. Everyone has been wondering when they'll get to play it. For news on that, let's hear from Midwinter's Josh Holmes. Yeah.
Thanks, Jeff. I do have a really exciting update for you, but first, I just want to thank the many thousands of players who've been testing the game with us over the past year. Your feedback and your support means the world to us. We couldn't do this without you. But today, I have big news to share.
Explorers, it's time. You'll face off against many others. There are countless strategies and paths to success. Find the ones that get you back alive.
This is where the real fun starts.
I've been preparing this for years. Now, I need you.
Keep up, if you can see me.
Minutes.
Time yeah. to
light the fire. Oh, just a countdown. Second.
Now it's going to be a good time, isn't it?
Everything is in place.
What if it's like 1 month?
Begins now.
Closed beta.
All right, so there you have it. The PC closed beta for Scavengers starts right now. If you're part of our community, you can play with your existing Steam key. But we're also opening up 50,000 slots for new players. So go to playscavengers.com, sign up for free, and we'll see you in the game.
Oh, is this
I feel
that,
like I should know what this is.
Yeah, it's that, like, infiltration.
Oh, right, yeah.
This one looked awesome.
Oh, right.
Didn't they show this at last year's Game Awards? Is that where it was?
I think so.
That was during the Xbox or PlayStation event.
Yeah, it was during one of the other.
Oh, okay. I didn't think it would have happened in any point.
Yeah.
Anything, and I would have believed it.
A close range arrow shot.
Yeah,
overkill.
Yeah,
it's quiet.
It's reminds me of Assassin's Creed multiplayer.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's a 400 vibes. Yeah, for sure.
We're all outlaws.
I like that one.
Good. Play early May 7th. Okay.
Give it a spin.
3 day early access. Okay.
A good spin.
Full spin. I'm gonna spin it before putting it in the machine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Almost Philip Glass there for a second. Yeah, anytime music starts when Jeff is talking, everything that follows is an ad. In case you didn't know.
Dude, Jeff's perfect target.
I know, man.
Sephiroth.
Wait, were you a drone? Like flying through the vents and stuff? I wonder if you were like a drone if she has like.
I think it was just a video. Yeah, I think that was just a camera.
You thought you could get rid of me.
Well, there's a moment where like the door locked and the
Anyways,
camera was like, oh,
Instagram
I'll go this way.
And the Game Awards have teamed up for 6 new AR effects you can share to Instagram Reels. I played with them yesterday at home and posted to the Game Awards profile. Check it out. You can transport yourself to Final Fantasy VII's train station, transform into the Doom Slayer, don the mask of the Ghost of Tsushima, sneak through The Last of Us, or even become Zagreus from Hades. To create your own, just head over to the Game Awards on Instagram, click on the effect icon, and share to Instagram Reels. And I'll be back later to show off some of your beautiful creations.
Instagram Reels is annoying.
Straight up bad.
Cyberpunk car in it?
Oh, yeah.
Cool car. That fits.
It's kind of a funny way to hype up a game.
Free on December 11th, yeah.
Play this other game.
That's a cool collaboration, I like that. You gonna give the spin one?
There you go. Forza cross Cyberpunk, and later Keanu Reeves, Johnny Silverhand himself will be joining us to present the Best Direction Awards, so stay tuned for that. But welcome back. Now, coming up next, we're going to present the Best Ongoing Game Award, and the Twitch community thinks Fortnite is going to win that with 47% of the votes. Well, let's find out the Twitch community is right. We're going to present the Best Ongoing Game, which recognizes five outstanding titles that continue to deliver for fans. Here are the nominees.
Best Ongoing Game.
Here I go!
Got a control.
Our enemies stand no chance against
this.
Is
this the actual
power.
First award? Game show?
Yeah, I think so.
That's crazy.
No, the actor won.
Yeah.
Oh, you're right.
Right.
That's right.
Yeah.
All right. Well, now it's time to reveal the winner. The nominees are joining us here. Hi, guys. All right, here we go. And the winner is... The Game Award goes to No Man's Sky.
Oh,
wow.
Whoops. Chugging a beer.
Amazing.
Wow.
We're going to get a drunk Sean Murray here.
Twitch is right, yeah. Jeff. It's normally Fortnite. It's always Fortnite that beats us. thank you so much.
shit.
We're really lucky. You know, we get to
forgot how charmingly befuddled this guy always is.
No Man's Sky is such a wonderful game to work on, you know? It's not always easy, though. So moments like this, they mean a lot, you know? This means a lot to me, means a lot to the team. Thank you so much. Thank you to the community for continuing to support us. Thanks.
That's awesome. I must give them so much.
Congratulations.
Yeah,
Sean Murray, No Man's Sky, Best Ongoing Game. Now, every year leading into the show, there's always a lot of speculation, a lot of games that you might be anticipating.
Oh,
but there are
the
always a few
one.
You're not expecting. Like this one. Check out this world premiere.
We were expecting it because they sent everybody announcements yesterday. But, okay.
Healy's not expecting you expecting it.
So many.
Mm-hmm. Not enough. More.
There's Vin Diesel for a second.
More.
Your new Reddit game. Sign me up.
Oh yeah, dude.
Alien 3.
Hey man, get up.
It's not that weird Outlast one, right?
Outlast Trials?
Dead Space vibes.
With drunk the guy that created Dead Space.
Oh, well, there you go.
Oh.
Are you seeing this?
Everything's from the guy who created something.
Something
unintentionally on point.
I mean, it's just like the Back for Blood thing. It's like, if you're not going to make Dead Space, we will. Somebody should.
Yo.
Shit. That is a top tier freak.
They got him.
I mean, guess not main character.
Yeah. Also, they said there was nothing to fear.
good monster.
This is Black Iron's transport ship.
So here's this prison thing that the stickers were hinting at.
You are cleared for landing.
Oh. Wesker vibes.
Yeah. I don't know what this game is, but I'm
intrigued.
So intrigued.
22.
Yeah.
2022, okay.
You're not going to know for a while, I guess.
So is,
you know.
Okay. The game settle in. Tied to PUBG, or is that a different game? Are they making two games?
Crafting.
Yeah,
I'm feeling some Dead
about.
Space vibes, and there's little wonder why. You know him from his work on Dead Space and Call
Jeff,
of Duty.
Stop.
Here's the CEO of Striking Distance Studios, Glenn Schofield. Hey, Glenn.
He yeah. streams.
Thanks,
Jeff.
The
well, the Callisto Protocol has been in development for over a year and a half with a team
this
of
side,
well
yeah.
over 100 people on it. It's a single-player, third-person, story-driven survival horror game set in the year 2320
Excellent.
On Jupiter's moon of Callisto.
Into
Our
it.
Goal is to make the single most scariest game for PC and consoles, and we're so excited to be able to show it here tonight.
Nice.
Awesome. Thank you very much, Glenn. Yeah. We're looking forward to hearing
cool.
more about
yeah.
that next year. All right. Announced back in July, Warhammer 40K Darktide is a four-player co-op game from Fat Shark, the developers behind Warhammer Vermintide 2. Well, tonight, they're sharing a
yeah,
first look
baby.
At the gameplay. Check this out.
See it.
Wow.
Dude,
keep it
back,
dude.
Oh,
dude.
Yo.
Yes, you can.
Awesome. Yes.
Wow.
This is actually probably our game of the year.
So
what's the
matter?
This
game
was.
He's
oh, the man. Best. Oh,
yeah.
My God, dude.
So big.
Yes.
I'm hyped for this game.
We are gonna play the ever-loving shit.
Oh yeah. Although it's a little weird to not just be melee, you know? Sword girl. Left for dead.
Now
that's
it is time
right,
to recognize some other winners. In the category of best art direction, the nominees are Final Fantasy VII Remake,
Hades?
Ghost of Tsushima,
Ori.
Hades, Ori and the Will of the Wisps,
yeah. Yeah.
and The Last of Us Part II.
Ori.
And the Game Award goes to
40K Dead,
Ghost
it.
Of Tsushima. Congratulations to Sucker
Whoa.
Punch.
Whoa!
Nice.
All right.
The
photo
best
mode.
Action game. The nominees are
people
Doom
mode.
Eternal,
this is a very, very pretty
Hades,
game.
Yep. Half-Life Alyx, Neo 2, and Streets of Rage 4. And the winner is
Series 4. Just happy to be there.
Congratulations.
Just happy to be there.
Happy to be there.
In the category of best VR AR, the nominees are Dreams, Half-Life Alyx, Marvel's Iron Man VR, Star Wars Squadrons, and The Walking Dead Saints and Sinners. And the game award goes to
If it's not Alyx.
Alyx, congratulations to Valve. For best sports racing game, those nominees are Dirt 5, F1 2020,
running through
FIFA
these.
21,
yeah.
NBA 2K21,
it's almost
Tony
as
Hawk's
though
Pro
he
Skater
knows
1 and 2. And the game award goes to
F1 2020.
Tony
Hawk's
Pro Skater 1 and 2.
Yeah!
Congratulations.
Right. Yeah, it was funny because it was like,
that's a win
once
for
I saw Tony Hawk,
like,
oh yeah, that's it. Yeah,
voted
so
on Twitter
award.
This year,
no
the nominees are Elden Ring. There I said it. God of War sequel.
Elden
there I
said it.
Horizon Forbidden West. Resident Evil Village and
God of War sequel.
The Legend
sequel.
Of Zelda Breath of
That's
the Wild
bizarre.
Sequel.
This is so weird.
And
That's
your
so
most
amazing.
Anticipated game is
So Ragnarok is not
Elden
the name
Ring.
Of that game.
Probably Legend of Zelda.
Congratulations to From Software. All right.
There
this
I
next game
it.
Comes from the
this
creators
would be a good
of
time.
Tom the Fulbright Company and Annapurna Interactive present one part road trip, one part mystery, with two familiar voices. Check it out.
Is
this
Saranax?
No, we've seen this.
No.
We got a little taste of this.
My name is Tess Devine, and the world is passing me by. I guess as I get a little older, I'm starting to feel how things change. They decline and go away. That's how it was with my grandma. I loved her so much. I thought I knew her better than anyone. But looking through her old things, we found hints of something she never told us about.
The art style is cool.
A man who wasn't my grandfather. A burglary ring. Some sort of lost fortune? We can't ask her about these things anymore, so we have to go looking for the answers ourselves. My mom and I are out on the road, searching. I don't know what we'll find, but whatever it is, I know we'll find it together.
Open roads.
Had we seen this?
I don't think so.
Dude! So sick.
There's another road trip game that has a weird animated style.
Shout out to the Americans, one of the best shows of
all time. Once again this year, we're excited to share some stories about people around the world who are making a positive impact on the gaming community. These are our global gaming citizens in partnership with Facebook Gaming. Our first honoree tonight is Latinx in Gaming. Check out this important story.
When I was starting in the games industry as a Latinx person,
I felt quite invisible. It still feels like I'm the odd one out.
I felt alone. I was often the only woman and the only Latino woman in the room.
I think about how hard it was for me to get where I am today, and I don't want anyone to go through that anymore.
And welcome to Latinx in Gaming, our content, our voices.
Latinx in Gaming is a group of people that are dedicated to supporting other people of Latinx descent in the gaming space.
The past 3 years, we've just grown from a really small group into thousands.
This was no longer just about game developers. This is about streamers and students and journalists and marketing and fans.
Paved the way for people like me, paved the way for people in our community.
Just knowing that there's somebody out there doing what you want to do empowers you to chase it.
It's a really beautiful thing.
I'm trying not to cry, I was this close. Oh, okay.
Hey everyone, my name is Anna Donlin. I am the executive producer of Valorant, and I cannot believe that it has been only half a year since we launched this game. Our Valorant community has shown up in such a huge way, helping us take this tax shooter from an idea to a home for tens of millions of players around the world. To celebrate this, we've teamed up with the Game Awards to highlight one of the most vital pieces of our community. Honestly, the ones that got us started in the first place are Valorant streamers. Together, we ran a fan vote to name the best emerging Valorant streamer from our global community list. We'll announce the winner before the end of the show, and then we'll all go raid their stream together. Again, I want to thank you all for playing Valorant, and I'll leave you with just a taste of what we've all done together this year.
The potential of Valorant. I love it.
Let's go, baby!
Oh my goodness!
I got this.
Oh my god!
The Slayer's time is now.
What a transition.
Yeah, what a transition. I'll say. Dude, Doom Slayer in Fortnite. Let's make it happen. Need it. Did. Want it. He's a hunter.
Earlier today, we tweeted out that there is a special event happening right now in Pokemon Go. Well, now's the time to bring out your phones and start catching because we're officially on a Wooper Watch. And they are so cute.
What?
We've partnered with our friends at Pokemon Go to keep an eye on the waterfish Pokemon. And throughout the night, we'll let you know when large numbers of Wooper will appear in the wild. We've also been told you could encounter a shiny Wooper if you're lucky.
Wooper
so
watches?
Open up Pokemon
watch,
Go.
Dude. I want to
have Wooper watches as easy allies.
I'd much rather have Wooper watch than Hytrain.
Just go easy.
Yeah.
Cloud support, probably. That damn door.
Coot.
What was that kid's name?
Get up, detective. One last time.
Oh.
The great city at the end of the world is waiting. So, get out there. Solve the murder with a unique skill system at your disposal. Carve your own path across an award-winning open world. And uncover even more in this groundbreaking role-playing game. Meet and get to know more of the locals.
Welcome to reality, baby.
Sure thing, champ. Lead the way.
If you could only find your gun.
It's okay.
With full voice acting for every single one of the city's beautiful people.
That's awesome.
Yes, I'm going to unplug the microphone, okay?
And leave a bigger mark behind you in new quests.
You're big boys, you can handle it.
Cars in a different place too.
Enjoy the definitive edition of this hit RPG. March. Disco Elysium. The final
What's
cut.
A, five?
A free upgrade for all players.
Oh nice. Shit.
Awesome. Cool.
Alright.
Upgrade me, daddy.
Chat, the game is amazing if you haven't played it. Yo, I've been thinking about getting a record player finally.
That'd be a good final.
People have sent me like 5 record game soundtracks. So I'm like, I'm not
Welcome sure. back to the Game Awards. That's so exciting. Disco Elysium news. You may remember last year they were, I think, they won the most awards out of any game last year at the Game Awards. So awesome
Big
news.
Dice
All right.
Behind them.
Well, now we're going to talk about BioWare's Dragon Age franchise. Excited. It is known for its story and its characters.
Oh.
And right now, the team at BioWare wanted to give you a little sneak preview of what to expect in the next game and where it will take us.
A little
Enjoy.
Sneak preview.
Poor Jones. Developer diary incoming, Jones.
Yep.
Is it a dev diary?
I've got tyrants.
How far away is this game?
22, probably.
Seen friends lose life and limb. But there's always someone bent on breaking the world.
It's BioWare.
That's a good joke.
It's time for a new hero.
BioWare.
No magic hand.
It's Keanu Reeves.
No ancient prophecy.
Ryan Reynolds.
The kind of person they'll never see coming.
Yeah.
We've got your back. I've got your back. Demons. Dragons, Darkspawn, even the Dreadwolf. This is your story.
You name it?
Is it just called Dragon Age?
I guess it's just Dragon Age.
Yeah, who was that guy?
I need some lore context
All
there.
Right,
who
we're back
that?
And I'm...
He's in it.
I'm trapped in our set now. I don't know what's going on. All right, well, next we'll have a look at an exciting new tactical squad-based roguelite game set in the Endless Universe.
It.
Here is another new game announcement.
So many trailers.
Underwhelming for Dragon Age.
It's definitely fire, recognize dude. That guy. Shout out to bands.
Yeah.
Okay,
alright. I play as that guy?
Weird. Definitely take the Jellyfish band.
Seems interesting, dude. Nice formal edit.
Orcs Must Die vibes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
We're gonna be doing as we get closer to the actual game.
Yeah, starting to lose interest now.
Mm-hmm.
They did say it was a roguelite. Okay,
this is the game. Here we go.
This really does feel like Transistor and stuff.
What a cool song, Garb.
Endless Dungeon, really? Okay.
Cool. Sega.
Huh.
All right, Endless Dungeons, very cool. Our next world premiere comes from South Korea, Crimson Desert, the new open-world action-adventure game from Pearl Abyss. This next-gen game offers in-depth, story-driven single-player content in an MMO setting. What you're about to see includes actual gameplay footage.
Yeah,
this
Endless
is
Dungeon
the
was
beautiful
already a thing.
And merciless world of Crimson Desert.
Totally different than Dungeon of the Endless, okay.
Oh.
Is this like a Black Desert spinoff?
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Oh, sure.
I wish I enjoyed Black Desert more than I do.
Same.
Nice character creator.
Yep.
Oof.
Good looking.
That's pretty.
Topography. Ray tracing on.
HDR showpiece. Man, this looks cool. Dude.
Eat your heart out, Elder Scrolls.
Yeah.
I was thinking of Elder Scrolls too, Jones.
Characters.
Axis confirmed. Yo, dude. Catacat.
Loomy.
Is it like voxel or something? The way that it is compressing is weird.
Might just be the stream.
Dogma vibes.
Yeah. Dude.
Wow.
Look at the way the leaves move when they walk. That's cool.
Oh yeah, now we get into like weird trailer choices here.
Yeah, you can't just put some wind in there. Come on now. Gosh, I wonder what they're saying. I'm so intrigued.
Dramatic.
Orcs.
Yeah. Bend the knee.
Like, this song has nothing to do with anything happening.
Yeah.
It's also very quiet.
Yeah, it's pretty quiet.
Did you, brother?
Overwatch? Chord progression?
Shadow of Mordor.
This is your destiny.
That's a weird time to cut.
Weird cut? Yeah, weird time
to
cut.
Now we get sound effects.
There's definitely something interesting about this, the way the world is being rendered. They hired the Godfall intern to cut the trailer. That's funny, Chris.
It's actually not that bad.
It's not that bad.
Screen shake needs to go away.
Yeah.
Shake.
I'm sure you can turn
down.
It off.
Oh my god. Yeah, they'll let that one fix.
Dude, he needs a stutter. What the hell?
If you have screen shake and your performance is enough to sniff, like, it just makes everything freaky.
Yeah.
It's lengthy, so you can't even see what's happening.
Sound is weird. Whoa. Ice bridges.
Oh, Indiana Jones.
Yeah. Is it framey or is the?
No, that's a game.
No, that's the game for sure.
I mean, and just remember, there's like with no other players on the screen yet.
Single player. In this.
Hey, it's that Unreal demo. Can't you
Yo,
that
leave
Unreal
the bear alone.
game like this, it really hinges on how good it feels to play it.
Yeah.
Well, the combat of Black Desert is fun. It's just like a mindless grinding.
Yeah, so that might, the way that thing's falling apart might play into what you're saying, Ian.
I definitely think that the whole world is being rendered as like, I don't know if it's voxel or something similar, but everything is destructible.
Yeah.
Whoa. It has that kind of grainy vibe to it, and the way that the water in his fur is compressed. It's like really pixely.
Yeah. Strong drink.
Yeah,
that's a good
I appreciate the enthusiasm, but like the effects on this game need to calm down.
Yeah, so like they're building it right now.
Yeah.
Okay.
What's that room?
An RTX 4000 for this.
Also crazy to have such a long trailer, so much gameplay, and not one line of dialogue. Nothing. Like, not setting up this world at all.
Black Desert, known for its incredible dialogue.
Is it related to Black Desert, or do we just think that because it's desert in the name?
No, it is. Pearl Abyss is the Black Desert Dev.
Oh, they're the Black Desert.
I love having new IP and new teams on stage. South Korea, that's fantastic.
Yeah, I mean, it's early, but it's interesting.
Now to present our next award, he joined me in Fortnite earlier this year, the star of Tenet, John David Washington.
It's a long trailer too for
Game Awards. Hey,
John. Yeah. Hey, Jeff. Yeah, that was a long trailer. Thanks for inviting me to the Game Awards. As you know, in Christopher Nolan's latest film, Tenet, I played a character called the protagonist. Very literally named narrative.
Most people
and I thought
don't
that was
know
cool
that.
Name for a character. It reminded me a little bit.
I knew that.
We're all the protagonists, helping to tell the story of the game with our choices. Great narratives in games are the perfect balance of that feeling of being in control, but also being guided by brilliant storytellers.
This is going to be a.
And so,
Fortnite
these are the nominees for best narrative.
Best narrative.
Would not win that. I told you no one gets out of here.
Oh, they got credits on here too.
A touching reunion.
This can't be real.
One name.
And the Game Award goes to The Last of Us Part 2.
He didn't even put in that pause.
This is the first award acceptance speech I've ever done, so I wrote it down so I wouldn't mess it up. But okay, here we go. This is amazing. First off, it's such an honor to be nominated with so many incredible games that came out this year.
Nothing like
so
having
truly,
someone
truly.
Win an award for narrative and be
course,
surrounded
I've
by books.
Of course,
I've
got to thank my co-writer and the director of The Last of Us Part II, Neil Druckmann, who was courageous enough to tell such a ballsy story. And a big shout out and thanks also to our other writers, Josh Scher and Ryan James, and of course the entire Naughty Dog studio. This game is what it is because of the collaborative nature at that studio and their love of narrative. And of course, thank you mostly and always to the fans. These characters meant so much to us and we're really touched that they resonated with you as well. So thank you.
Right now, we've got a very special guest who has some exciting news for all you virtual chefs out there. Joining us all the way from his kitchen, it's the Swedish chef. Chef, are you there?
Yo.
Yes.
He's got a little game award.
Oh, and I, again, this being remote makes this actually sell so much better. That's a roll out of desk.
The super duper hot spoon. Oh, the spoon. And for the noodles, and for the worst
noodles,
and for the chicken. The chicken is for the
chef, I'm so sorry to cut you off, and you're looking sharp in that tux, by the way. And my Swedish, it's a little rusty, but I think there's been a little bit of confusion, honestly.
No. It's for the win. Thank you for the shooting.
It's for the win.
It's not only just a Kyle bit, Chet. This is Kyle's kitchen.
No, Chef, I'm so sorry, but you didn't actually win a game award. That trophy you've got, honestly, it kind of looks like leftovers. Anyways, you're supposed to be sharing an announcement here about a co-op game.
The coop?
No, a co-op game. Like a fun game with a playable character named Swedish Chef.
Me? For the Play-Doh?
Yes, that is why you're here, for a world premiere. Let's take a look.
He's an overcoat?
Of course.
Yeah.
That's great. Yeah, so.
Beautiful.
Awesome.
Yes. Big headlines.
Big headlines.
Free?
Free download.
And there you have it. What do you think, Chef?
Furniture.
I wonder if he's built for the big and the number one
for the movie and for the poopy.
All right. Well, congratulations to the Swedish Chef. This time it's real. Swedish Chef is playable in Overcooked All You Can Eat on PS5 and Xbox Series X, and he's available right now. Coming up, Gal Gadot is presenting our Games for Impact Award, and we'll head to Abbey Road Studios to celebrate Mario's 35th anniversary with the world famous London Philharmonic Orchestra. But right now, let's hear from Dr. Lupo about a new initiative at the Game Awards, Future Class.
Hey, y'all, I'm Lupo, and tonight I'm honored to partner with Gillette to introduce the Game Awards Future Class, a group of thinkers, dreamers, and pioneers who represent the bright, bold, and inclusive future of video games.
Games have really changed my life, to be honest with you. My name is Royce Payne. I'm a senior computer science major at Morehouse College, and I'm currently playing on the Morehouse Maroon Tiger gaming team. We see other big colleges are able to have these gaming teams, and they're winning scholarships. For us not to have it, we're like, this is a lack. We need to get rid of this lack. We're just a collection of HBCUs who have different passionate gamers who want to compete against one another. We played against some good competition so far. Just being able to really break into that space and open the door for others to come behind me, that's huge for me.
Oh, hi everyone. I hope you're enjoying the Game Awards. I'm Alana Pierce, coming at you live from my mansion. As someone with a chronic respiratory illness, I've had to find some unique ways to deal with the 2020 situation. Like maybe I go for a swim in my Olympic-sized that's not Olympic. The Olympic one is indoors, so. But I know that there are some people out there watching this that are depending on things like vaping to try to calm themselves down. However, the high levels of nicotine that you can be inhaling can actually worsen your anxiety and just kind of fight against the mental health battle that is this year. Not that I would know, because
happy to be here with you guys, you know, during the no vaping ads.
But that doesn't
usually
mean I'm not trying to look out for you.
When these happen.
For those of you who are looking to quit vaping, which I hope you are, This Is Quitting is a free text-based program with a free built-in support system. Text Game Awards to 88709 now.
Here, show me some Bowser's Fury gameplay?
Yeah.
Show me. Let's go.
No sound effects.
Yeah. The sound effects are in text.
No date?
Disappointing. I want that Mario music back. That was
we know
fun.
The date.
Back in 1997, I wrote a story about two game developers coming together to make an unreal franchise. Tonight, they're teaming up again for this epic game store world reveal, which you can play right now.
Oh, okay.
I thought that was Samus.
Our arms are up.
I thought it was Samus.
Yeah. Yeah. Tactical advantage have increased. Test those.
Wait,
weapons.
Did it say Unreal Tournament?
Yeah.
Also,
yeah.
It did.
The Warframe Unreal Tournament?
Unreal Tournament crossover?
Accuracy is ultra kill. Otherworldly.
What?
That's cute.
It's a crossover.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Maybe they're adding Unreal Tournament stuff to Warframe?
Correct. That's what it is.
Enemy casualties are enormous. Your progress
unstoppable.
In line with projection.
I used to play Unreal Tournament so much. Free Unreal Tournament weapon bundle.
Huh.
Welcome back to the Game Awards. Earlier, I asked you to head over to Instagram to post our Game of the Year AR effects to your reel. Let's check out a couple of your creations.
Damn it.
Looking great. Keep posting on Instagram, and I'll share some more in just a bit. Now back to your host, Jeff Keighley.
Small pause.
Thank you very much, Sid.
Looking
great.
Last
month, Call of Duty invited players to unravel a conspiracy decades in the making with the release of Black Ops Cold War. On December 16th, Season 1 kicks off. Free multiplayer maps, more weapons, and more operators. And for Warzone players, a massive update of content, including a new close quarters map, Rebirth Island. Here's your first look at the gameplay of Season 1.
The shoes are definitely, like, happening. They're there.
That was chasing ghosts. He has some pieces of the puzzle.
Okay, I'll be right back.
No, he's a piece
of
himself.
Get a nice call, dude.
He won't live long enough to work that out.
Looking great.
Looking good.
Oh, we got some black sound.
Uh-oh. DMCA. Yeah.
Remix.
Time for the remix.
Top
for the remix.
Vengeance is mine. Go. I am going to.
We're felons now. Blame Jeff. Jeff will pay for all of our legal fees.
Mm-hmm.
Strike inbound. You have no idea what's coming.
I think I have an idea.
Yeah.
I think I have an idea with what's coming.
He's trying to bait you, Adam.
No shit. I won't show him mercy. He showed me. What the hell?
Is that an epic flashback?
Kill the rest.
I'm intrigued.
Adler is mine.
Looking great.
Mario. We knew this year that the Game Awards Orchestra wasn't going to be easy to pull off, but we had to try. I know how much we all love video game music. Well, I'm really proud of what we've got for you right now. This is an anniversary year, the 35th anniversary of Nintendo's all-time classic Super Mario Brothers, originally released in 1985. Here to perform a medley of Mario songs from the legendary Abbey Road Studios in London. This is the world-class London Philharmonic Orchestra, led by Lauren Balfe.
All the strikes right in a row.
Big band, let's go.
Abbey Road, dude. That's
isn't that where like Skrillex?
Yeah.
Cooper hates Mario. Confirmed.
Don't come after us, Nintendo.
Please.
Ian left during Mist, Blood leaves during the music. But,
oh, yeah. Nice.
I think I've heard this one before.
Yeah. I love serious musicians playing something so jolly.
Play that music.
This is from Morrowind, right?
Yeah.
Morrowind 64. It's from that one Morrowind mod.
Right.
Oh, yeah. You're right.
The cat one.
This is what I wanted in the Mario 64 remake.
Oh, for sure.
Oh, yeah.
Ah! That galaxy music, dude.
Mm-hmm.
It hits a different way when it's illegal, you know? Like more goosebumps.
Did they just get sunshine?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay. So. There's no need for that. There's no need for that.
Every Mario is a 10. No need.
Yeah.
No need for quarrel. Hostility.
Yeah.
play one-wing games in the towers.
Man, that was awesome.
Trying to hit a lot of things, but
that kind of makes everything better, doesn't it?
Wow.
Thank you to Lauren and the Harmonic. But we'll be back again later in the show. And Eddie Vedder's coming up.
They
too,
had to finish
so
before the crazy desert trailer.
Was three times the length
of that. Right now, I know it might feel normal tonight to see all these games, but we're all in lockdown, and I know we all can't wait to go back outside to travel the world, meet new people. Well, until then, here's a game where you can do all of that as you explore and record disappearing cultures in a strange, beautiful world. This game is just stunning, and it's coming to PlayStation 5. Check it out.
Exclusive.
All right.
Into it.
Yes.
Ghibli vibes right now.
Our grandparents lived for 1,000 years.
Oh, yes.
And our
parents, I'm so into this.
Had a century to themselves.
Really well.
But us, we have one season.
Yo.
Yo.
Slice of life games, dude. Sign me up.
Her walk, I love it. Cue the table saw outside. PlayStation.com.
Wow. That's a spin.
Red map is fake.
I would spin that shit.
Beautiful. That's seasons. All right. Well, now it's time to present another Game Award. She's the star of the upcoming film
Just
Wonder
seasoned,
Woman
Jeff.
1984.
Yeah, geez,
here is Gal Gadot. Hey, Gal.
Thanks, Jeff. I'm honored to be here at the Game Awards. Lots of video games are fun to play, but each year, a select few games deliver a deeper message. They focus on subjects that can be historical, political, or deeply personal. The Games for Impact Award honors socially progressive projects
that
have the potential to inspire real change in the world. Here are the nominees.
Games for Impact.
It's described as a bicycle road trip.
Nice. Awesome. Most character.
Nothing good comes from stirring up old memories.
We don't really have a choice about that.
Solid. Games for Genshin Impact is pretty funny, Jeff.
We knew we had to resist, no matter the cost.
I feel like.
And the Game
Kentucky
Award goes to.
Being so split up probably hurt it here.
Tell me why.
Yeah. Tell me why.
Kyle, I'm the Evolve community manager of Tell Me Why. And on behalf of the entire team from both Dontnod Entertainment and Xbox Publishing, thank you so much for this award. And thank you so much for all the love that you've shown Tyler and Allison and their journey. I'd like to express our team's deep admiration for all of tonight's nominees, especially those that have used their platforms to tell stories about trans and queer people with sincerity and heart. Here's to a future where even more marginalized people can see themselves and their experiences truly reflected in the games they play. Thank you so, so much.
Congratulations. Everyone's joining us live. The tech is working. This is amazing. And it's so cool to see everyone. All right. Well, right now we've got another brand new game
there,
announcement
Jeff.
For you. Check this out. Unexpected.
Unexpected, huh?
Is that the name of the game, or are you just saying it's unexpected?
Yo.
That's part three.
Yo, what?
Dude. This Horizon?
It's yeah, it looks...
Nah. Vin Diesel.
No, that is Vin
Diesel.
Vin Diesel.
Diesel. It's Vin Diesel.
Let's go.
Dude, what the hell?
My brain, I'm going for it.
What?
Okay.
Unexpected.
Unexpected.
Very unexpected.
What the hell?
I can't take it seriously.
It's tough. It's a little tough, I gotta be honest.
It's tough.
If a car comes out, I'm
please say family's everything.
Oh,
tribe is everything.
I can't.
Dude, what if The Rock shows up?
Look out, Kratos.
Up?
Yeah, look out,
The Rock is the villain.
Tyrese Gibson.
I can't take it seriously.
I can't.
You could, like, one Game Awards wasn't enough.
Yeah, exactly.
But it also just looks like...
Yeah, the animation's kind of...
How many games has he done now? Five? Four? Five?
Oh, I'm not sure how many.
Four and five.
I mean, there's the unicorns.
That's the greatest wheelman ring.
Yeah.
Turok.
Oh, shit. Okay.
Turok.
Yo, this just got interesting.
The Diesel being upstaged right now. No, he's not scared. Yeah. He's dying for the best.
Oh.
Oh!
Oh my! That was high stakes.
It's weird. It feels like they disconnect between different elements sometimes.
Is he gonna take down this dinosaur at that speed?
You know he is, dude. He's gonna ride it.
The guy fell over like his armor was.
What are these black frames?
Yeah, what is going on? Yeah.
That's like the second one. Yeah. Who cut this?
Well,
and
there's
it's like interlaced.
Yeah, I've been seeing the interlaced.
Vin cut it. This is a Vin cut.
They spent all their money on Vin.
What?
What is the tone of this game?
I don't know.
She
I'm
just
confused.
Stuck her tongue out at a thing that someone saved her life and then was immediately killed by.
Hey, another day.
Tech.
Vin tribe.
It's like Horizon.
It's like Horizon. Yeah.
If he's in
prequel
Horizon,
DLC.
So funny.
There's no way this is too jank. Looking better in here, in this pre-rendered cutscene.
It's a big guy.
Just be Turok, dude. Just do
if
it.
It's Turok, dude, that'd be so fun.
He's like Turok's dad.
What if the game is literally called Turok's Dad?
Yo, what?
I would pre-order.
So he's like from the future or something, or like.
Like
he is
this like tied to Riddick stuff again somehow?
He literally is Vin Diesel.
Unexpected.
Avatar.
Very
Avatar?
Unexpected.
Yeah.
Oh
it's an
my art god.
Game.
Art 2?
Arc 2?
What?
What does that even mean?
That was a roller coaster ride, man.
Okay.
Wow.
What the hell?
That's right. Arc 2 starring Vin Diesel. And the team at Studio Wildcard has one more announcement for all Arc fans. Check this out.
Can you feel it?
Wow.
The balance of nature has been altered.
Right now.
There is someone out there who may
that was
change
a very long
our
arc
fate,
announcement.
Who could lead us out of the darkness. And yet I wander, hunted and alone on this strange new world. Will she be able to survive?
Gladiator.
Do I need to watch Fast and Furious to understand the
That's
lore?
That's
Pro,
man.
Yeah.
Whoa, dude, anime prequel tie-in.
I didn't realize that Ark was operating on this level.
Yeah, dude, the Ark universe. Oh!
2021, they are taking over.
Yo, Ark feels important back then.
Yeah!
Cobra Commander.
I gotta get caught up on the Ark, the Lord. Yeah.
Wow.
This is on Netflix, obviously.
Good boy.
Netflix, right? Gerard Butler.
Jeffrey Wright.
Jeffrey Wright. David Tennant.
Crazy cast.
Whoa.
Elliot Page.
Carl Urban.
Russell Crowe in Vin Diesel.
Wow.
Oh my gosh.
What is going on with
Russell Crowe? Russell Crowe going to fight
Vin Diesel. It
has
been a crazy year for Fall Guys. It became a massive phenomenon, and we all had fun with it this summer, especially when we were all in lockdown.
Oh, they think it's top is Vin Diesel and Fall Guys now.
With a Winter Wonderland for season 3. Here's your first look.
They're already in season 3.
Oh, yeah.
Season's like 2 weeks long.
A while ago.
Yeah. Season 2 is Summer Game Fest.
Remix.
Yeah, I can barely
move. Remix.
Yeah, we know that and everyone
telling you be a super domain yet.
It's the most even the song is the recording.
I mean, the recordings were from a game.
Sure.
So I went to install Ark Survival Evolved on Steam, and it's 101 gigs.
Yeah, everything is gigantic now.
Damn.
What about that wanted you, inspired you to install Ark Survival
Evolved? Ark is important.
I feel like there's something I'm missing.
Dude,
maybe there's something in that 101 gigs.
I tried it, dude.
Yeah, it'll probably be an immediate install.
After Cyberpunk, how do you room on your computer?
Cyberpunk is small compared to some of these things. There'll be scary ghost stories and tales of the glories of Christmases long,
long ago.
Yeah, Ark seems like it'd be fun.
Choose an Ark retrospective.
Yeah. Nice.
If it doesn't have Vin Diesel, I kind of lose interest.
The Game Festival
you know?
Is going on right now, and you can stream all the Game Festival demos using any device you own with GeForce Now.
He full-on delegitimized Ark 2.
Lots of amazing games you can play all weekend long. All right, coming up next, Todd
Holland,
Nolan North, and the award-winning multiplayer award awards and announcements. And later, we've got Reggie, Keanu Reeves, plus Eddie Vedder from Pearl Jam. Playing his song from The Last of Us Part 2, but right now, Elite Dangerous is a space sim MMO from Frontier.
Oh,
players
right.
have been exploring the galaxy for nearly four decades. Here is the gameplay reveal of Odyssey, which lets you explore on foot for the first time.
Yeah, baby, legs.
Oh, David Bowie.
Remix,
are
remix.
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 All right, we're saved. Nope.
Remix. That's the line that'll get you.
Remix.
That's the one.
Remix.
We're super toast. We are toast.
Yeah, man.
I'm just gonna call the lawyers.
Is David Bowie big? Is that like a big thing? Is it like a recognizable song?
This song fucking rips, though.
Yeah, it's pretty good, too.
Can we get an amazing Japanese?
I'm very disappointed.
Shooting dinosaurs. I didn't know they'd put shooting in. Be dangerous, chat.
Shooting is definitely something that games don't do a lot of, so I'm glad that they're doing it.
This is Christ, it's because, well. It's because it's called Odyssey. Don't you get it?
Nice.
Oh, remix.
Early 2021.
So far away.
We all need a way of coping with what's going on in the world. Games is an incredible way of doing that. I'm Jennifer Hazel. I'm a medical doctor. When I started specializing in mental health specifically, something clicked. I realized that all my life I'd been using video games as a way of nurturing my own well-being, and I wondered if other people could do that too.
Hi, this is Dr.
And so I established Checkpoint to bring mental health resources to the gaming community.
What is mental health?
We use games as a medium to raise awareness and to reduce stigma and to provide real tangible resources to people who are struggling that they can use in their everyday life. Above all else, I want people to know that it's okay to be struggling at the moment. There are resources out there, and it will help, and it will get better.
Welcome to Enoch, a hellhole of madness and misery.
Trying hard.
If you don't want to end up as one thing, what worked for you in the old world won't work here.
No.
Running and hiding are simply not viable options. Here, if you plan on surviving, you need to shift your mind into a higher gear. So let me walk you through the mantras of survival.
Could I have your attention? Could you imagine going into
first,
a game like
cover is for
run and hide?
Yeah, that's right. You can use cover. Nobody's stopping. But you're a biological sledgehammer. Act like one. Chuck yourself into the fray. Two, your powers are on tap. You feel that tingling in your fingertips? Your powers are ready to be unleashed. Don't keep them waiting. Three, you've got to kill to heal. There's no use licking your wounds. Want your health back? Get out there and take it. Violence breeds vitality. And finally, guiding philosophy to end. You have to think aggressive. Before you find a
place to be. Yeah.
Yeah. There are a lot of things I don't like about Chad.
Sure.
Wow.
Sorry, Outriders.
It's just that Outriders Godfall jus de vivre.
The tinder.
Just
that. You better think twice before you hand it to
using
them.
Circular. This instantly.
Yo, what?
Yeah. You got any people too?
Seems like it, but I mean, it's not. I think we've seen this before, actually. Dude is still out there doing a table saw in pitch blackness.
Struder came like, huh?
This does have massive Struder vibes.
Struder, fist of Struder.
He is fist.
Forged in shadow torch. Okay. My skin.
Remix. This is a remix.
Well, not too many remixes.
Dug deep in my heart.
You don't want this to happen to your Xbox, right?
Can you imagine if you walked into your living room and your Xbox was doing this? It's like, Xbox, stop it.
Xbox, like, sorry. Did you find the games?
Ryzen, Radeon.
Xbox, I don't need you to spell AMD, I know.
Get ray tracing.
Put some games, please.
Hey, what's up, guys? It's Tom Holland here. I am in Atlanta on the set of the next Spider-Man film, but I am honored to be a part of the Game Awards
tonight.
Yeah,
you are.
You know that for the past few years, I've been working on the Uncharted movie, which did involve some extensive research playing the games. I'm honored to be playing Nathan Drake. What I can assure you is that we really want to honor Naughty Dog's amazing games. So this film tells you how Nathan Drake became the character we all know and love. It is now my honor to introduce my good friend, Nathan Drake. Please welcome Mr. Nolan North.
He's there.
Thank you, Tom. I could not be more proud of you. You know, someday when someone searches for Nathan Drake on IMDb, and you are the first result, I will only be remarkably bitter. You know, video games allow us to connect with friends, family, and complete strangers. We can share memorable experiences beyond the confines of our own homes, or even travel to vast new worlds with our buddies on the couch next to us.
Does anyone
of all
else
the
get
years
the
I've been
vibe
grateful
that Nolan
for
North
multiplayer
is actually
games,
their dad?
They've never been more important to us than they were in this historically crappy, rotten, no good, cursed year. These are the nominees. for Best Multiplayer.
Best Multiplayer Game, presented by Instagram.
The game that didn't come out this year.
Yeah, it came out like a long time ago.
Yeah.
I love you.
Category. Really tough category. What if Valorant wins?
That'd be crazy. I can see Fall Guys taking it.
I think the Game Award goes to get some recognition.
Among Us.
What?
Wow.
They're like, what?
Oh, thank you so much. Oh my God.
Wow.
Oh, I can do this. All right. Thank you, Game Awards, and everyone who voted for us. And also congrats to all the other games nominated. It's an honor to have won Best Multiplayer category. Our goal with Among Us from the beginning was to create a fun experience amongst friends. 2 years ago, Among Us started with local mobile and then online and PC, and the rest is history. Now more than ever, finding ways to connect with friends is increasingly significant, and we're so happy many of you turned to Among Us to
Wait,
play
is that Keely
with friends and family.
Thank yeah, it's like a cutout of Keely.
Dual Studio and our other partners for helping us navigate all the excitement. Thank you to our moderators and the fans who have been on this journey with us for the past 2 years. And big thank you to our friends and family. You've helped us test and been incredibly supportive through it all. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Wow.
That's so sweet. Tonight, you've been using Instagram's custom Game of the Year AR effects to add a snazzy trophy to your reel. Let's check out a couple of those. You're all winners in my book. Keep making those trophies, and I'll be back with more later.
I love her.
Congratulations, Dana Schlock.
So
later,
great.
Among Us, the new Grift reveal. All right, now we've got another brand new game announcement. This one is fun.
Let's
it's one of
Jin's
your favorite supernatural
Among
horror
Us dead.
Franchises,
looking great.
And
looking
it looks
great.
Like a bloody good time. Check it out.
Supernatural horror, you say?
Excuse me?
Horror?
I had a real life once. I had a wonderful girlfriend, Linda. Together we drove to a small cabin.
Evil Dead! Holy shit!
Namakan Ex Mortis.
Yeah, dude.
Oh my God!
It seems an archaeologist had come to this remote place to translate and study his latest find. It was never meant for the world of the living. The book awoke something dark in the woods.
They're putting everything together.
Dude.
It took Linda. And then it came for me.
Ben Moore, dude.
Yeah, Ben.
Yo.
The game.
It's also the
Yo.
You could drive
Nothing
a car.
Like the game is your subtitle.
Full playthrough immediately.
There you go. Evil Dead, the game. Next up, a classic game franchise is being remade. Take a look at this announcement.
Dino Crisis. Remade. Yeah, Dino Crisis. Right, right, right. It's time. Here it is.
Wait.
No, just kidding.
I don't know.
Oh.
Tell.
Oh my. Well? Oh, it's Ghost.
Oh,
yeah. Goblins. Yeah.
Shit.
Oh, I thought it was going to be that one.
Yes, cool. Dude!
Golly.
Yes!
Try that in the way it looks.
It looks a little weird.
At first I was like, oh, no.
Yeah, I thought that storybook art was
It does. It does look like a bubble game.
But it has like, it's like goofy, so it's kind of...
Resurrection.
Cool.
Okay. Yeah, all right.
Yeah.
All right.
Cool. Still cool.
Not mad
date
about
staying
it.
Staying up there.
Yeah.
Come to Smash Brothers? Oh. Remix.
I was born in 85.
Capcom Arcade Stadium.
Remix.
What the
Free
hell is
download.
That?
Free
Arcade
download.
Stadium.
Okay.
Okay, all right.
We love ourselves some Capcom Arcade Classics. Okay, we're now going to recognize some more winners. In the category of Best Independent Game, the nominees are Carrion, Fall Guys Ultimate Knockout, Hades, Spelunky 2, and Spiritfire. And the game award goes to...
Yeah, it's probably
Hades. Congratulations, Super Giant. Yeah. For best audio design, those nominees are Doom Eternal, Ghost of Tsushima, Half-Life Alyx, Resident Evil 3, and The Last of Us Part 2. And our winner is
The Last of Us Part 2.
Congratulations, Naughty Dog.
Yeah, that makes sense.
For best role-playing game, nominees this year are Final Fantasy VII Remake, Genshin Impact, Persona 5 Royal, Wasteland 3, and Yakuza Like a Dragon. Jeez. And the game award goes to Final Fantasy VII Remake. Congrats, Square. In the category of best simulation or strategy game, those nominees are Crusader Kings 3, Desperados.
Another weird combination.
This is a weird one.
Microsoft Flight Simulator and XCOM Chimera Squad. And the winner
one
is
one sim and a bunch of strategy.
Right.
Crusader,
Crusader.
Flight Simulator.
And in our fan one wonders category, if there was a sim choice, you voted tournament style to pick your favorite games. The final
one
five
sim
nominees
all the
were
games.
Doom Eternal, Ghost of Tsushima,
Tsushima
Hades, Marvel's Spider-Man, Miles Morales, and The Last of Us Part 2.
You already
2.
Know that?
And the winner, as you may know, we announced it online. Congratulations to Sucker Punch, Ghost of Tsushima.
Nice.
Now we've got one more for you. This is for best fighting game. And here to help us out from Netflix's Cobra Kai, two great rivals.
One Punch Man.
Ralph Macchio and Yuji Okamoto.
Hey, what's up, Game Awards?
Game Awards, what's up?
No, we haven't even read the nominees yet.
Not you.
Because I'm not in a game.
Oh, come on. You were in a game? Karate Kid for Nintendo 1987, and your karate was weak.
All right, Yuji, listen, whatever, okay? Why don't we just read off the list of nominees, huh?
Right.
Best fighting game, Granblue Fantasy Versus.
Mortal Kombat 11 Ultimate.
Street Fighter 5 Champion Edition.
One Punch Man, a hero nobody knows.
Under Night in Birth. And here we go. The Game Award goes
He didn't say the full thing.
Give him a break. He's just doing his best.
No, it's just funny.
Somebody blew this thing?
I got you, Macho. And the winner is Mortal Kombat 11 Ultimate.
Congrats, guys.
Awesome.
All right, congratulations to Mortal Kombat, and thanks to Ralph and Yuji. One of the things I have really been missing this year is flying around the world. But luckily, we have one of the most beautiful games of the year to help fill that void a little. It just won Best Simulation Strategy Game, Microsoft Flight Simulator. And next year, it's coming to Xbox. Here's what that's going to look like. It's an airborne view of our wonderful world.
Yeah.
Incoming Wonderful World song?
Remix.
I see skies out blue. Is the... Yep.
Stop!
I see trees.
Remix.
Red roses too.
Oh, yeah.
Nice snowy.
What an amazing song, though. For me
and you. Remix.
We're moving to YouTube platform.
What a wonderful world.
We're moving to Mixer.
Yeah,
it's gonna fill up the whole hard drive on an Xbox.
Yeah.
I just deleted it from mine.
We're moving to Mixer.
We're moving to Mixer.
A dead platform yet.
We're getting the Mixer remake.
Wow.
Hey, I've been there.
Sky is calling?
I really like the tagline.
I don't think so.
All right, Microsoft Flight Simulator looks amazing, coming next summer to Xbox. And now it's time to take a look at another game coming to PlayStation 5. Check it out.
This is your God of War 1 Heber.
Oh, okay. PlayStation Studios.
Silent
Hill.
I will go there now.
Oh no! This is the. This is that.
What is this? Just kidding.
Michael, that older lady in space game.
That was
wrong. We got baited. We got baited.
PT, you bastards!
So rude.
This game looks cool, but...
This game looks amazing.
Cool. It looks really good.
But damn it!
We got baited.
Yeah.
I knew something was off with the helmet thing.
No, yeah, the helmet was... I'm really bad at bullet hell. I can't remember the... Returnal? Is that what this is called?
Yeah, I think so. Let's say they've actually, like, come up with a better name.
Yeah, Returnal. Interesting name, but
it's just cool. Another
end. Yeah.
Another but it really turns out this is Silent Hills, guys.
Dude.
When you beat it.
Ah!
All right, we will be back in just a moment with a man, a meme, a legend, Reggie. He's going to join us. We've also got a new look at a game that you might remember from one of the craziest, most unscripted moments in Game Awards history, Joseph Fares. Plus, Eddie Arthur will play his song as the last of his part two. Later, Jacksepticeye joins us from Europe to present Content Creator of the Year, presented by Adobe.
Poor Reggie.
Lots of great stuff coming up here on the Game Awards. We will see you right after this.
What are you training for? What will you do with this strength?
Oh, there's an action. Yeah.
My answer to this question used to be simple. It's not so that I continue winning. I train so that I never lose again.
Remix.
I like the remix bit.
Super that game's pretty hard. Boy,
that game's pretty hard.
Oh, December 23rd.
That's
Whoa.
This year.
Okay, finally.
Oh, it has a date. Okay.
Interlacing.
Oh yeah, I need to. Or an ad break, I need to refresh. I'm a little behind here. It's hilarious because, like, I'm getting when I refresh, like, I get the ad during the ad break.
Oh, I'm locked in so I didn't even add.
Yeah, and
top 10 plant bosses.
DMC4.
Resident Evil.
Final Fantasy 12 maybe has a cool one. One of the bombazes.
Cuphead.
Shout out.
Cuphead, you fight
Hi,
that
I am Mary
flower.
Yeah.
Cool.
Taking list from Netflix's Cobra Kai. We're here to settle one of the great rivalries in gaming.
This is Abby versus Ellie from The Last of Us Part 2.
I am Team Ellie.
I don't understand
one of the
this.
Wow,
all
they are.
Yeah, and Abby
yeah, yeah, this is weird.
Seems a little forced.
Team Abby all day.
Yeah.
What? Oh, yeah, she's like a perfect physical specimen. If she gets a nap and some food in her, she
like,
can probably
why do they need to be
small
pitted
car.
Against
And
each
she's
other.
Nice to dogs.
Well, Ellie is
yeah.
an artist and a beautiful singer.
Abby could be a good singer.
It's like it doesn't fit the tone of anything.
Of the game.
And it's not what the game is about? Like,
no. That's weird.
Honey, is it you?
Villain 10.
This is what I thought this was earlier. Wait, maybe? How many road trip games are there?
How far are you?
Seven.
How many do you want there to be?
It's a new genre.
Be careful with the people that give you a ride.
Quite a few, actually, yeah.
And don't travel with someone you don't know.
This is a different road trip game.
We love you. Honey.
I know the one you're thinking of.
I am like
four people in a car, all
I Yeah.
And that's like what happens. I'm definitely going with the bikers.
You'll be
yeah, season. Sorry, everything else. Season is the... Oh yeah, remix.
Yeah.
Desert bus.
Road 96.
Wish list.
Remix.
No more FOMO.
Did Broad City invent the term FOMO, or was that around before then?
Hey everyone, welcome back to the Game Awards. And before we went away there, I meant to tell you that was a look at a new Rogue coming to Rogue Company. So make sure to check that out this holiday season. All right. Well, you'll probably remember this next developer from a few years back. He is not a fan of the Oscars, but he is a fan of colorful language and our show. He's in Stockholm, Sweden tonight.
Aww.
And he wanted to give us a new look at his next game. Here is my buddy, he really is my friend, Joseph Ferres. Hey, Joseph.
Really?
Truly my friend.
What's up, Jeff? So nice to be back at the Game Awards. As you can see, I'm in the middle of a mocap shoot, working on our next game, It Takes Two. Trust me when I say this, Hazelight's next co-op only experience, It Takes Two, is gonna blend narrative and a huge variety of gameplay never done before. And today, we're gonna have a gameplay reveal. A word exclusive. I know you like word exclusive, but this one is even extra exclusive, my man. Yeah. Anyway, we're also gonna have something that we had in A Way Out. We call a friend's pass, which means you buy one copy, you get one copy for free. You know, if you play with your friend, nice. You can play for free. Anyway, it's coming out March 26th. Enjoy the trailer. Goodbye, boom.
Nice. We did it.
So much energy.
Yeah.
This is the story of a magical king.
Holy shit.
One of wizards and warriors. It's an epic tale set upon the high seas.
This is not what I expected it to look like.
Space. Pew, 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 pew.
It's also a bit of a winter wonderland bobsled sort of thing, you know?
Will this game say fuck the Oscars at some point?
There'll be an Easter egg. Yeah. It'll be written in text somewhere in a book.
Almost forgot they used to be humans. Do you want to know what this story is really about? Huh?
Dr. Hakim.
This is the story of Cody.
Remix.
And Meg.
Why'd you look like a blob of clay?
Wanna change back? Then you need to fix your relationship. This is a story of passion.
Today I'm gonna throw up.
Oh, you're a doll, Cody. You've nothing to
this throw. Right?
Told you.
It takes two, baby. Remix.
Of attraction.
Oh, you feel it? Bounce house.
I feel stuck.
It was a spell, I am telling you.
If it is a spell, how do we break it?
Music tonight is off the rails. Give me some
space. It should have been local recording.
This is a story of collaboration.
Yes, rolling balls.
Whoa.
This looks pretty fun.
Yeah, I am super into this.
So much
excitement. Garden Warfare vibes.
Yeah,
there's so much stuff happening.
So much going on, yeah, wow.
Just me and you.
What are you doing?
So he qualifies as a remix now.
No.
Okay. You're entitled to your own opinion.
Cute. March 26th.
Can't wait.
What an absolutely crazy game. Joseph showed that to me last summer when I was in Stockholm, and I'm like, we have to show this off. There's so much gameplay there. Thank you for that, Joseph. All right, now I'd like to welcome a longtime friend and supporter of the Game Awards. He was there in Vegas for our very first show back in 2014, and he's been back every year since. We weren't going to let the streak stop this year. The retired president and COO from Nintendo of America,
Reggie.
But still a boss, Reggie Fils-Aimé. Reggie!
Jeff!
Yeah, headset, dude.
What's his
doing good, Reggie. Take it away.
Absolutely. You know, I'm proud to present the very first award for innovation in accessibility. During my time at Nintendo, we had a mantra, gaming for the masses. And we pushed that agenda with Wii, Nintendo DS, and now Nintendo Switch. But today, approximately 1 billion people around the world experience some form of disability that makes gaming challenging for them. This award was created to highlight the efforts throughout the gaming industry to make software and hardware that enables games to be played and enjoyed by the widest and most inclusive audience possible, because gaming is for everyone. Here are the nominees.
Innovation in accessibility.
So many options.
That spider.
And the award goes to The Last of Us Part Two.
Really good about
pretty extensive, yeah.
Yep.
Hello, I'm Matthew Gellens, and this is my fellow designer and neighbor, Emilia Schatz. And from everyone at Naughty Dog, we would like to thank you so much for honoring us for this year's Innovation and Accessibility Award.
Thank you as well to the Game Awards for choosing to add this category, and to all the other developers who have designed and advocated for accessibility in our games. We hope that together we can continue the momentum to push our industry forward. As developers, we know how one small design decision can unlock the entire game for a player. Games are special for their ability to blur the line between player and character, providing a means for personal engagement with narrative that is unrivaled and other artistic mediums. It's up to us to ensure that everyone can experience that for themselves. We'd like to thank our terrific group of accessibility consultants, and we'd absolutely could not have done it without your insight and your detailed feedback. Thank you.
We'd also like to thank our partners at Worldwide Studios, our senior producer, Sam Thompson, the user experience research team, and our dedicated accessibility QA testers. And we'd also like to thank everybody at Naughty Dog. This was truly a team effort, and every department had a part to play in removing barriers for players with disabilities. Lastly, we'd like to thank you, the players. Nothing makes us prouder than hearing stories from players who were able to experience The Last of Us Part II without assistance, using our accessibility features to remove barriers that would have otherwise excluded them. From both of us, thank you so much.
Thank you.
Congratulations to Naughty Dog, such an important category, and I'm proud that we're able to recognize innovation and accessibility here at the Game Awards. We're going to do that every year moving forward. This next world premiere gives us our first glimpse at next year's big adventure for The Elder Scrolls Online. Enjoy.
Elder Scrolls?
Online.
Online. Every time I see this game,
they usually do. They usually go a lot on these trailers.
Yeah, every time they show it, I'm just like, oh, missing out.
The Argonian swamps.
EverQuest just had their 27th expansion, EverQuest 1.
Wow.
That's so weird. I was just thinking about EverQuest right before you said that.
7. Or it launches soon.
Oblivion.
of Oblivion.
From imposters in Among Us to the visual beauty of Genshin Impact, mobile gaming has had an incredible year. Coming up, I'll be revealing the winner of Best Mobile Game presented by LG Wing, the world's first 5G swivel smartphone, powered by Qualcomm Snapdragon. And later, the first look at a brand new map from Among Us. The Game Awards will be right back.
Yeah, I wanted to hear her low-key drag some Instagram filter people.
The line between light and dark is so very thin. Let's cross it together.
That's a lot of guardians.
Fate comes knocking sooner or later. With this power, we make our own fate.
I wonder how many we've got left to go.
It's been 2 hours.
Yeah, it's been over two.
Well, two of the real show and half hour of the fake real show. Well, yeah, I gotta puke this on my PS5.
Load up.
Wait, isn't that?
Hey, I've been there.
Yeah, they put the Cosmodrome in when they deleted the other four planets.
Yeah, it's so hard to look at any of their like sci-fi shooting.
The Guardians
be even
will
remotely
come
amazed
through.
After seeing this.
They always
do their environments.
So good.
The Pussy 5, yeah.
Star Wars.
Oh, remix.
Stay alive and meet me in Caesar Black's Cantina.
The thing I love about Black Spire Outpost? You never
it's
know
the money-making opportunity.
This is a galaxy convention.
Yeah.
I am a highly trained resistant spy.
There's something wrong with this place.
Received your distress call. No. The council did.
Hey, your pirate friend stopped by what while you were out.
Yeah, I was very confused.
Yeah. It's a VR game from 1995, John.
Where is it? In the cannon.
Yes, that's pretty cool. The Vader three-part series is neat.
But if it's on Oculus, why did it look so old?
Huh. Yeah, that frame rate.
DLC good. Time?
VR is tough to capture.
Oh, yeah, Don, maybe.
Nah, this is just
nah,
a
this is, yeah,
this
it's
is
the,
mad.
This is
mad.
Sorry, just kidding.
Go, now!
We haven't seen our Scorpion mode yet, so I'm taking you on right now. We'll be on Saturday.
Yeah. Who's on that? Damiani and Brad?
Tonight, go to WDBlock.com to get one of the fastest internal SSDs on the market, the SN850 NVMe SSD with heatsink.
I heard SSD. What?
They quoted him in their commercial.
I got one of those. Look at that.
That was the
someone I know. Had real problems with this.
Wait, there's an ad during the Game Awards that is just a Jeff Keighley quote? Wait. What layer are we in?
Ouroboros.
We've just heard from our friends at Pokemon Go that there is another surge of Wooper appearing, so we're implementing another Wooper Watch.
Wooper Watch!
Wooper Watch!
Phones and get to catching. And
we've got a Wooper Watch,
Pokemon
people.
Pokemon Go recently implemented its Go Beyond update, which introduces
very disappointed they didn't get a life-size Wooper to walk
to
50, by in the background.
And
yeah.
makes earning XP easier for everyone. Pokemon originally discovered in the Kalos
like the
region,
ongoing
like
Beetlejuice
Chespin,
gag in community?
Fennekin,
yeah.
and Froakie are also making their Pokemon Go debut. There's also a lot of bonuses happening now, and it's never been a better time to play Pokemon Go.
Looking great.
Looking great.
They've always known you would come.
Do you know why this is like when you watch movies on cable? Lies. And they like let you watch an hour with pretty much no ads, but then you get the last 15 minutes and it just keeps breaking in.
You must find your full voice.
Is this a visual beast?
That's what the quote said.
Over seven shades of brown.
The backgrounds are pretty elaborate from what I checked out.
To present our next award, she's a host and producer from IGN and your host for the Game Awards pre-show. This is Sydney Goodman.
Whenever people are in the same room now, my brain is like, no.
Mobile games were once defined by their limitations. In a way, we celebrated the games that excelled despite their platform. As technology has closed the gap, releasing on phones is no longer a limitation, it's an asset. It's never been more apparent than tonight, where the nominees for Best Mobile Game have found massive audiences because of their platform.
Gotta be Genshin,
here
right?
They are.
Yeah.
Best Mobile Game, presented by LG Wing and Qualcomm Snapdragon.
Tell me about this poll. I don't want to see the poll.
Oh, you have to go to the thing, the control thing on the right, and say uncheck visible.
Now I take to the sky.
Bro, how is this not Genshin Impact?
Pokemon cat.
And the game award goes to Among Us.
Whoa.
Hey. Wow.
I just want a lot of people to know in the comments of the video, a lot of people told me Genshin Impact would like hands down win this. It wasn't even going to be close.
And congrats again to all the other games that were nominated. We originally designed our game Among Us
again,
to be
beating
played
Call
on mobile
of Duty.
Devices. So if you found yourself with a group of friends, you could easily
Coach
set up a game.
Furious,
right? We wanted our game to be accessible to any level of gamer and wanted to create
I
a fun experience
buy them
to be
tonight.
Shared amongst friends and family and whoever.
Can you imagine?
We want to thank our players first and foremost. Among Us would not be where it is today without you. Whether you played Among Us when it was mobile, local only, or played for the first time just yesterday, thank you from the four of us. again, big thank you to Robot Teddy, Dual Studio, and all of our other partners for helping us during all of this. And thank you to our moderators and the fans who have been on this journey with us for the past 2 years. And a big thank you again to our friends and family. We love you and miss you. And thank you for being so supportive. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Congratulations to Among Us, second win of the night. Next up, Monster Hunter franchise is coming to Nintendo Switch in 2021. Yeah. This is a new look at Monster Hunter Rise.
See that like $200 plushie of the Capcom selling in Japan?
Everyone shut up.
A huge pack of monsters in a giant stampede. They attack the village in a frenzied rage. Nobody knows why this happens, but it came close to wiping out our village last time.
Yeah. Throwing fruit?
Demo, please.
Yeah, everyone in Kimura, we've all been training for this moment for our entire lives.
We need you to protect Kimura Village.
Is that man a Rathalos?
Damn, no demo date.
There it is.
Oh, wait. No, there
January.
You go. There it is.
Month away.
Hey, I'll take it.
Got excited for a second. Yeah, January's pretty good.
That was the...
All right, over on Twitch, the next poll is for Content Creator of the Year. Vote now for who you think is going to win, and we'll find out in a little bit who wins that category. But next up, he's one of our industry's great performers, and he plays Joel in The Last of Us. Here is Troy Baker.
One day on the Sun of Last of Us Part 1, Neil, our writer and director, asked me and Ashley what we would have been if we weren't actors. I thought about it for a second and replied that
this is wild new haircut.
I always imagined I would have been a singer. Ashley just shrugged and in her charming and offhanded way said, I would have been an astronaut. Neil incorporated parts of us into Ellie and Joel. Space and music became major elements of their stories, creating touching moments between them. One of those moments, now indelible in our memories, incorporated Neil's story as well. Not as a writer, but as a father. It involved a song he would play and sing to his daughter every night. That song was Pearl Jam's Future Days. One day, Neil asked if I was comfortable playing it in a scene he was writing for The Last of Us Part 2.
Do you want me to get ready?
Now, I don't generally get nervous, but I understood what that song meant to Neil and to the game. And the truth is, Neil can play that song better than me. But nobody can play it better than the person that wrote it. From Seattle, performing Future Days, here's Eddie Vedder.
All right, muted.
Hit it, yep.
Hit it. It's... All right, so let's do our own rendition of this, all right? It's a nice looking guitar.
Yeah.
Blame Twitch.
Yo, ambience.
Blame Twitch.
Tweet why, at
why
Twitch.
You? Because, yeah, this has already been flagged before on other stuff. Light. And it'll get flagged.
Nice.
Yeah, this gets flagged all the time.
He sounds like Cat Stevens.
I think this would be a good time to slap on some Instagram filters.
True.
Looking good, Eddie. Looking good.
I have Snap filters.
Oh, yeah. Nice.
Not Instagram filters.
Good enough.
Looking good.
Well, I broke my camera. Oh, there it is.
There's going to be some tech in the future where like streams of in real life stuff are going to have alternate soundtracks when you do the DMCA free option.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Just like games have now.
But are they like really compelled to do that? Like that's what we want, but is that something internally that they're like, mm-hmm. we got
to push this tech? There's games that you can disable tech. Copyrighted music.
Oh, a lot of games do
original
it.
Song.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Like Spider-Man, Miles Morales.
Lights are fun.
We might have those lights. I was just gonna say, I think we have that in the streaming stage.
We're on Eddie Vedder's level, Ian.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's Eddie time. At home though.
Yeah.
Eddie at home. Yeah.
Eddie part at home.
Yeah. This is every Eddie. Day, Eddie. Yeah. Like we're, you know, that lighting bar is us at our best. Oh, Eddie. When was the last time you played a game, and what was it, I wonder? Among Us on mobile, probably. Perfect dog, Huber. Perfect dog.
We muted it because we're going to get a DMCA strike.
100%.
Yeah, I mean, saying
we're,
that because it's live, it won't get flagged is just incorrect, because the version... of The Last of Us, in The Last of Us, got flagged on YouTube.
Yeah, all the time.
For the original.
We feel it with you, viewers. We're there with you.
It's all right.
Spirit.
Shut up, Eddie.
I remember when...
shut up, Ed!
Yeah, game so trailers awesome. When they had some musical performances. We were pretty much told, like, straight up that, like, yeah, we'd have to cut it out and not put it up.
I once a cappella sang a thing, and it got a copyright strike.
Yeah,
it's over.
Song Future Days.
Straight into Last of Us Factions.
That song you might recognize from The Last of Us. And
he's gonna be in The Last of Us.
I really appreciate the way that was used, especially bringing Joel and Ellie together, connecting through music, and I thought maybe it was cool too that made you want to perhaps pick up a guitar yourself and write a song for your loved one. It is nice to be part of this, show my appreciation and be part of this year Game Awards, and what a fascinating way to tell a story. It's just getting better and better all the time, and it was cool to be part of it. So thanks for having me, and enjoy the rest of the show.
Nice.
Oh, nice to give him a little speech.
Doesn't
again.
Get better than that. Mm-hmm. Thank you so much, Eddie Vedder, for being here on the Game Awards. All right, now here's another brand new game to show you for the first time.
Game.
Factions.
Arc 3.
Desperados 4.
You can run.
Okay.
For a long time. Sooner or later, he'll hunt you down. Father Almighty, let me tell you the news.
Every game is just the same.
There you go. It's just slappy.
Yeah.
Cowboys.
And then we're like flying wild.
Oh, yeah.
I wonder if this is a new IP, because this is reminding me of something. There was like a third person, I think it was like PS2 or something.
Hunter the Reckoning?
No, you were like a little cowboy guy running around, smacking him dead.
Tell the Midnight Rider, tell the Rambler, the Gambler, the Bagpipes.
Evil West.
Weird West.
Hard West.
Evil West.
Right.
Yeah. Cool it.
Cool it. It was not called Evil West, so I don't know.
There you go. Evil West. All right. On Twitch, we What's asked you to predict the winners in Content Creator of the Year. And the Twitch audience said Valkyrie with 44% of the vote they think is going to win. So the award for Content Creator of the Year is coming up next. Presented by Adobe and artist Boss Logic, used Adobe Creative Cloud to create tributes to the nominees. You'll see those in a minute. And we've also got announcements from Among Us and Fortnite. But right now, Scarlet Nexus is an upcoming action JRPG from Bandai Namco. Here's a look at the brand new trailer. Mm.
Scarlet Nexus.
Scarnex.
The virtual brain link cable will now be connected. This will hurt much more than it did in training.
Virtual cable.
Anime? No thanks.
It doesn't look. It doesn't look like it's a good time.
Good. Yeah. Seems like you're okay.
Connect your minds and become one. Use the red strings to save the world.
Anami, who do I?
Don't bother resisting. I will obtain the red strings.
Top 10 anime clips.
I wouldn't let that happen.
Oh.
Whoa!
Okay.
Don't take my red string, Daddy.
Oh.
Focus.
Nice. Summer.
Did we know that?
Play it on
the
Xbox.
I don't think so.
They didn't say the name of the Xbox. Is it the all new Xbox?
I am depressed when I look at the status of where we are in terms of depression and anxiety and inattention. We owe it to all the people that are suffering to be really creative and to try things that when you first hear it sound crazy, like a video game is medicine. My name is Adam Ghazali. I am a neuroscientist and a neurologist.
I know that's about it. I just didn't say it out loud.
It started for me 12 years ago. I became really interested in this idea of creating experiences as a way of improving brain function. And this relies on a principle called neuroplasticity, the fact that our brain reshapes itself and modifies itself in response to challenges. And so that's how it all started for me, to create a video game that was carefully designed to challenge and reward the brain in a very specific way. And so what just happened a couple of months ago, the FDA cleared EndeavorRx as a medical device to treat inattention in children that have ADHD. This is the first time ever that the FDA has cleared a video game for any medical condition. So what we're talking about right now is to have a video game prescribed, just like we prescribe pills for conditions, and think about this as a new type
another
of
Facebook
medicine.
Game. It's not a Facebook game. Facebook is presenting these vignettes about people
the
around
world.
The world
is a dangerous place.
But it's goodwill advertising, too.
Yeah.
Only for the Facebook. Best can keep yeah. it safe. Become a tier one operative.
That game looked cool. The
plan.
The Endeavor.
Position. And execute. Do whatever it takes to neutralize the threat. Join the elite. Bring the thunder. Thunder Tier 1.
As gamers, you are just generally better humans, and the world needs you. Here at the Peak Humanity Procreation Facility, gamers from around the globe are donating their superior DNA.
What?
I'm donating.
I have powerful swims, and it can be yours.
Transcend humanity through gaming.
And how I feel about that one.
Okay. What?
Real awkward one.
Yeah. I'm uncomfortable.
Nope.
Skip.
It did feel like Salmon Globe. You're so right, Blood. The ads in the back half, so heavy. That Elden Ring keeping everybody around.
That makes sense. If the breaks get longer, you're still going to keep watching.
E3 2021, I guess, then?
For anything?
They do it like Suda 51 though. They show Elden Ring like as the credits are going with people in front of the monitors.
More game.
Welcome back, and as you just saw, EA Play is available now on new consoles, Steam, and Origin, and includes Star Wars Jedi Fallen Order, one of our nominees tonight, and a great game. All right, now on to one of the biggest games this year. It was created by three developers in Seattle, now four. You saw them. They've won two awards tonight. Interslot, they absolutely took over the internet with Among Us. Well, they sent us something special. This is the reveal of the brand new map for Among Us. Check it out, crewmates.
Cute. App hype.
Imposters, not for you.
Yeah, not for you. Sorry, Blood.
Twitter notifying me that Vin Diesel will be in the park.
The airship.
Come on,
welcome,
Twitter.
Welcome, recruit.
Most important announcement.
Get yourself acquainted with the layout of the Toppat airship.
That,
enough
that,
slacking. Go to
my
your
brain
task.
Can't even process the Vin Diesel.
Art feels important.
You may need to take a ladder to get to certain areas. Or maybe just take a nice shortcut.
Oh, that's cool.
Man.
Moving up. Choose a room to start in after a meeting. Someone keeps trying to sabotage us.
That's cool.
Stop
that's pretty...
their plan.
Yeah.
Keep your eyes peeled. We definitely have an imposter here.
Jones, do you think this map will allow you to be the imposter?
I hope so. I am undefeated at this game. Box for roll. So.
Airship. Cool.
Very cool nice. Idea.
All right, the Among Us team has another surprise. They've turned my face into a mask, and that drops right now on please. Twitch for the next 30 minutes. That's right. The
okay.
Jeff Keighley mask.
That's why they had it in the background.
Don't be sus. They came to me and said, all right, we can do this. Wasn't my request.
It wasn't me, I swear.
Anyways, Among Us Jeff Keighley match now available. All right, he's a hilarious content creator with over 25 million subs and over 13 billion views. He's joining us now live from the UK. Jacksepticeye. Hello, Jack. What's up?
Hello, Jeff. How's it going? Hello, everyone at the Game Awards. In a year when so many of us were separated from our family and friends, one thing remained the same. Our favorite content creators were still there for us. Their streaming, gaming, and sharing helped us fill the hours and feel connected, unifying us all with our shared passion for play. Here are the nominees for Content Creator of the Year.
Remember when he was in the year, that murder
presented
house
by
game?
Adobe.
Are you proud of me, Dad? What? Who is this man what? In my face?
Another one, Nick. That's you, baby. Nice. Helping. I'm down.
I'll die.
Wait, hold up. Wow.
Put my crown on!
Yes, I did! Bad piggy, bad! Help me! Look out!
Okay, looking down.
And the game award goes to Valkyrie. Congratulations.
Thank you so much to the game awards for nominating
the
me
right.
And to all of my friends
good job,
and
Paul.
Family
good
and
job, Paul.
Fans
you got it.
And my loving community for being so supportive of me the past 7 or so years of streaming and now to being Creator of the Year. That's crazy because there's just so many amazing creators. I can't believe. I don't know. It's just unbelievable. Anyways, thank you so much for the support. I am very flattered and honored to accept this award. And yeah. Thank you.
Adobe salutes the nominees for Content Creator of the Year at the Game Awards and all gaming creators around the world. Tonight, celebrate your creativity by
That's
downloading
us.
A free trial of Adobe Creative Cloud at tgaxadobe.com and get creating.
Joining me right now is the Chief Creative Officer of Epic Games, Donald Mustard. Donald, it is great to have you on the show. It's a yearly tradition. New Fortnite season. What can you tell us?
Who's it going to be?
Fortnite.
Oh, man. So Samus. Awesome to be here. So awesome to see you. This is amazing, Samus. Jeff. You did this yet again. I was so excited right now. New season has started. We just all battled Galactus together with our favorite Marvel heroes. And what that's done is it's left the Fortnite 0 point exposed. And Agent Jones is looking for all these hunters throughout all these different realities that can help him stop anyone from escaping from Fortnite. And we've already seen several characters come in, and we have one more that he's bringing in right now.
Dude, 47. How about 47? Who the hell is it gonna be?
He's Jolly Little Fish Man.
Oh, it's Master
Chief.
Oh
my gosh.
Yeah.
It is?
Yeah. Holy shit! They
there
did
it, is,
it.
Dude.
You did it.
There it is.
Unreal.
So you can be Kratos and Master Chief now.
Yep. Now
yeah.
We just
Damn.
Need Mario. Let's
Master
get Mario.
Master Chief comes this to Fortnite. You're
apart.
Getting them all, Donald.
Dude.
Isn't that crazy? Like Master Chief is just one of my most favorite characters ever in anything, and I'm just so thrilled that he can join the ever-growing cast of characters in Fortnite. And the coolest thing is he's going to be available tonight in Fortnite. You can go and get Master Chief.
Nice.
Shit.
And I know there's
Pretty
some
cool.
some more Halo coming as well, I heard.
Hey, yo.
Yeah, so I think, we didn't want it to stop right there. And so there's something else I think we should check out.
Oh, well, hello, sir. It's an honor.
Yeah.
Hey, Sarge, did you hear?
Oh,
I guess you already got the news.
What news?
Master Chief is coming to Fortnite.
Well, Fort what now?
It's only one of the most popular video games in the world, but more obviously, it's where we are right now.
Blood Gulch map?
Huh.
Wait a minute. If you had no idea that we're in Fortnite, then why do you have a cardboard cutout of Master Chief?
Perfectly regular reasons.
Whoa. You guys new around here?
The Chief got ninja. Eliminated by a sneaky blue!
That's no blue! That's Ninja! It's such an honor. I'm a huge fan of yours on Twitch.
Twitch? Is he twitching because he's blue?
Stop making us look bad in front of Ninja. We're Sergeant Griff from the popular web series Red vs. Blue. You probably watched it about 10 years ago. What are you doing here?
Well, it's more than just the Chief coming to Fortnite. This
map probably watched it about 10 years ago.
It'll be in creative mode starting at 10 a.m. Eastern time tomorrow.
Okay. Oh, so that's what we're doing in Ragnarok.
You mean Basin.
I'm pretty sure it was called something else. Either way, you can start reliving your favorite Halo memories here in Fortnite, and maybe add your own personal touches to the map.
Hey, wait, does that mean we can have dance battles? Come on, Ninja, what do you say?
Save it for New Year's.
Red versus Blue, Donald.
Plus. Yeah, isn't that so
I'm
awesome?
Stealing that applause,
it's so
man.
Funny. So what's awesome about that is that Blood Gulch was recreated in Fortnite Creative by this awesome creative team that call themselves Atlas Creative. And tomorrow at 10 a.m. Eastern, you'll be able to go into Fortnite and you can play Capture the Flag in a recreated version of Blood Gulch.
Oh my God.
It's going to be fun.
Everything is in Fortnite right now. So are you done for the season?
Mm-hmm. That's cool.
You know, I mean, Agent Jones is actually just kind of getting warmed up. So I think there's actually one more thing that we should show you.
Rick Grimes? Oh, no, it's
the, Norman Reedus and Michonne.
Yeah. Daryl yep. Dixon? Daryl what Dick- the hell?
And Michonne?
Robot is going to freak out, Brad. He's going to lose it. Holy shit.
Narratively,
he's gonna lose it.
That's a great upgrade
thanks,
for those two,
no
getting out of that
next,
reality.
On board.
Yeah.
Yeah.
All right, Donald Mustard from Epic Games. All right, come up in a moment. Keanu Reeves is going to present the award for Best Game Direction. We've still got a few more surprises. Don't go anywhere. Right now, let's hear from Rocket League on their new season.
Hey, what's up? This is Cascade. And I am stoked to be welcomed into the Rocket League's vibrant community in such a big way. I'm excited to work with Psyonix and Monster Cat to put together an EP for Rocket League's music season, Season 2. Starting tonight, you can get the featured anthem in the item shop and grab my free banner all weekend long. Let's check out the Season 2 trailer featuring my brand new track that I made just for you guys, and I call it Flip Reset.
Remix. Daryl Dixon.
Yeah, I don't know.
Remix.
Does a remix trick work when it's already a remix?
Right. I mean, it's really just about, yeah. You talk over it, be less likely to be caught.
Yo, when's Vin Diesel gonna be in Fortnite?
Yeah.
Give it time. We need him.
Yeah, that wasn't very long.
We need all the Vin Diesels.
Vin Diesel is Agent Jonesy.
Skyrim?
Finally.
Why we have Skyrim again?
Please tell me.
Boy. Again?
Please reveal
Stadia?
It.
Stadia?
Reveal it.
Oh my!
Luna?
No, that's Xbox.
Oh no,
Xbox?
It's NVIDIA.
Game Pass.
Oh, Game Pass.
Oh, Game Pass.
It's so funny that it got. Oh, there we go.
Every time.
Skyrim on a smart toilet.
Screamers. Oh yeah, Haven's on there. They got Jedi Fallen Order in there.
I hope the combat system in Dragon Age is different than it was in Inquisition.
3 months of Discord Nitro.
Hold see.
Yeah, you just checked that out, huh?
Well, maybe tune into Easy Update to Saturday.
Remember when they announced Sephiroth?
Yeah.
That was pretty cool.
Remember when they announced Vin Diesel?
No.
Killer Queen, dude. Shout out.
Oh, shit.
Wait, Yakuza's coming to Game Pass?
There's already a lot of them on there. Oh, it's the HD collection. Cool. Oh, Plan 6. So one day, the whole world.
Oh, and PC as well? It's a PC? Shit, dude.
Yeah, because I had...
Hell yeah!
Game Pass is really good.
Getting crazy.
Squee!
Just checked Pokemon Go on my phone, and there's Wooper everywhere. So we can officially declare another...
Wooper watch.
Wooper. Grunts there are also appearing in balloons and at Pokestops, and you can save Shadow Wooper.
I think it's the alliteration, but I fucking love Wooper Watch.
Make Wooper your buddy, take photos of it with Go Snapshot, and battle
Wooper.
With it in Go Battle League.
It's just, there's just
if you're
the
enjoying
perfect
Wooper
vibe,
Watch,
dude.
You'll
yeah,
love
Wooper
Pokemon
watch.
Go's December Community Day. Happening
serious,
this weekend.
Like,
and be sure to check Twitter after
like,
the show to see how many Wooper have been caught locally during Wooper Watch. Whoop whoop.
Okay.
Add.
Jones is on.
Anything that says mobile gets Jones.
It's just Cause mobile.
Yeah.
It's everything Jones has ever wanted. Yeah. It's all led up to this, Jones. The look on your face.
You sure sound like how to play. Here we go.
Uh-oh. My internet. My Switch went weird.
Uh-oh.
There you go.
This is Just Cause Mobile gameplay.
Yeah.
We're having a really good time, but it does feel like we've been watching commercials for 45 minutes.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Absolutely feels that way, yeah.
Yeah.
Oh, boy.
We've gotten into this Fallout 76 ads. Updates have transformed the game.
Okay.
It's better now, we promise.
Yeah. But remember how he made that joke about bugs before this game came out?
Gribe of Avalon. I see.
The Game Awards is back. We've got a lot of great show. Keanu Reeves still to come, Christopher Nolan, and so much more. And of course, we've got the Game Awards sale happening on all the platforms, including an awesome discount on Destiny 2. So make sure to check that out across all platforms. All right, for the next 30 minutes on Twitch, you can get a free cosmic wrap for Fortnite. There is a Twitch drop happening right now, so check that out too. This next game was announced last year right here at the Game Awards, developed by Airship and supported by Riot Forge. And now they're back to give you a first look at the gameplay from this indie title, the first ever single-player console game from the League of Legends universe. This is Ruined King, a League of Legends story.
Cuber out.
cutthroats, spirits, monsters. When you live in Bilgewater, you see some things.
When you live in Bilgewater.
Let's start the party.
That's the Queen of Bilgewater, looking to bring order to this twisted town.
And stay down.
The priestess of the Great Kraken, unmoved by fear.
This is destiny.
The legend. Whose strength is only eclipsed by his kindness.
Feel better now.
The terror from the deep who preys upon the living.
You won't feel a thing ever again.
The dishonored swordsman fleeing from his past like the wind. And a nine-tailed fox who devours the essence of her victims.
Delicious.
I see no fortune for those standing in their way.
That's giving me doubt.
Diablo, and then you attack once and it goes into one bees? Or what?
Yeah, it looks like
my blade.
Can't help but wonder what brought them together. Nothing good, I reckon.
Cool way to expand a story for Legends.
All right, Rune King, available on console and PC in 2021. Now to present our next award, a man who absolutely needs no introduction. Please welcome Keanu Reeves. Keanu?
Jeff, thank you. Greetings, everyone. I'm honored to be here to present the Game Award for Best Game Direction.
That Matrix
this category
haircut.
Recognizes the studio that demonstrated superior creative vision, setting an even higher bar for the entire gaming industry. Over the past months, I've come to really appreciate all the fantastic creativity that goes into making a video game. A special shout out to the folks and team at CD Projekt Red in Poland. I had an amazing experience playing Johnny Silverhand in Cyberpunk 2077.
Thank you.
And now, here are the nominees for Best Game Direction.
Best Game Direction.
This is a one-time gig. When it's done, we're done.
What we're doing here could change things forever.
I am a samurai.
You are the ghost.
You'll have a better home where you belong, here on Olympus.
I know you wish things were different, but they ain't.
And the Game Award goes to... The Last of Us, Part 2. Congratulations.
Mm. Man, thank you, Keanu. That's a real thing to say. Shout out to our game directors, Kurt Marginau and Anthony Newman. Wish we could be doing this together, guys. Man, what a year. It's an honor to be in this category with such incredible games. Direction is nothing without a team to internalize it, make it their own, and turn it into a game. And we're privileged to have such an amazing team, cast, outsourcing partners, our partners at Sony. Every single person that worked on, touched this game, helped shape it. And a big thanks to my former boss, now partner, Evan Wells. You guided us through thick and thin while we made this game. I can't tell you how much I appreciate that. Thank you to the Game Awards and to all our fans. Cheers.
Got promoted.
Yeah.
Congratulations, Neil.
Not my favorite game, but
all
like,
right,
the direction
we've still got one last
good.
Award to present, the big one, Game of the Year, presented by Christopher Nolan. And we'll also have a tribute to all the nominees performed
Shit,
by
Nolan
the London
the
Philharmonic Orchestra back at Abbey Road Studios.
Game of the Year is coming up next.
Okay. But right now, GTA Online continues to evolve. And next week, they've got their biggest update yet. Check this out.
I guess
GTA
that makes sense because they've got him in person.
Is this the right place for the party? Can we post? Is there a hashtag?
Heist. We're all here because of one man.
You're not on the mainland now, huh? Anything goes!
I've seen him going in like a trout, chasing some supermodel down the beach on a panther, mate.
I didn't understand even know a word of
I was like, he was there.
Lots of guards. I take security. I need someone to rob it. You're really obviously going to need a submarine.
Let's try and come out of this with all of our ears and a bit of suntan.
Best 5 days from now.
Mm-hmm.
Lucy Adam was born about 9,000 years before our time. In the year 515, after having federated the African continent, she set out to conquer Rome. It was on witnessing the consequences of this terrible battle that she decided to impose upon her people a strictly vegetarian diet.
There's a couple other games.
And it's in 1082, following the unexplained death of the king, that she was crowned Empress of Spain. It's in fact to celebrate this event that rock and roll was invented.
Oh, yeah.
In 1789, allied with the valiant Japanese, she discovered the real Indies, which had fallen into the hands of the bloody French. This was followed by the Great Devastation, a 100-year war that Lucy Adam ended before beginning the Great Reconstruction and establishing a lasting peace by banishing all forms of currency and violence,
as well as the use of selfie sticks in museums.
Lucy, are you with us? Okay, so for next week, don't forget your essay on the cultural stereotypes of the great civilization. How far will
Lucy
you push humankind?
Well done, Lucy, well done.
Well done. That game looks cool.
We've been having fun with Instagram's Game of the Year AR effects. Here are a couple more. Those effects are still available, so keep posting to your Instagram Reels. And coming up, we'll find out who's getting a real-life Game Award trophy for Game of the Year.
That would be pretty fun.
That is the juice player. She didn't drag him.
Finally.
Oh.
Oh, here we go.
Yeah.
Medal of Honor.
The biggest game of the year.
200 gigs.
Well, shit.
Private Jackson.
How bad have things gotten?
The German occupation has turned every neighbor into a possible enemy.
Very intense eyes.
Yeah, whoa.
Mm-hmm. We need more resistance members, but that's much easier said than done.
Drop your weapons. Make any move and we shoot.
Oh, please tell me you brought bazookas.
Everybody's eyes are
out of control. VR just kind of looks bad, except for Alex, if you're not in it.
Okay.
Looks really fun.
That's a piece of shrapnel.
We had to report for the drill.
It was something we had to do.
Connaissez deux personnes, c'est une de trop.
You want to hear the rest of the story?
I know it's going to be a tough job ahead.
Where's my sister?
But it's good for us to be together.
I think this is actually going to be
That's
pretty good.
That's all we can ask for.
Oh, this game's going to be crazy.
Legit. Available now. Right
it's
now.
VR to play over the holidays.
I think there was like a museum part of the game.
Welcome back to the Game Awards. I'm so excited about that Medal of Honor from Respawn in VR. Surprise, it's out right now. What an incredible trailer end game. I can't wait to play that, hopefully this weekend. All right. When the show ends, the games continue with the Game Awards Festival. You can play upcoming games and stream them on GeForce Now, which means no downloads on PC, Mac, or phones. Make sure to check it out. We got playable games available all through the weekend. All right, we've got one last world premiere to share with you. Check this out.
Come on, Jeff.
Come on, Jeff.
Last
Come on,
one.
Jeff.
Mass Effect?
We know now that in the early years
Star 4. That's War of the Worlds.
Roger, copy. Eagle, Houston, you're a go for landing. Over.
Secure a station. Unknown vessel approaching. We need first contact protocol.
Humanity now stands as partners of the galaxy.
Exiting away.
Godspeed.
What's that? Oh, my God. Directly down the dreadnought.
Engines are going crazy.
Yeah, that's Mass Effect.
We'll continue.
That's a great that subtitle.
See you in 5 years.
She was looking older too.
So wow. Yeah, yeah. Quite a Mass Effect 4, bro.
Yeah.
Not hype. Seven years from now.
I can't wait to see where BioWare is going to take that next. Wow. Very exciting. All right. Well, to present our final award,
needs to,
this man has created some of the most iconic films
BioWare
of all time.
Needs to stop
some of which screened this summer
so
in Fortnite. And on December 20th, I'll be sitting down for a conversation with him on YouTube to talk about the home release of Tenet and his illustrious career. And if you've got questions for him, which I'm sure you do, send them our way using the hashtag AskNolan on Twitter. But right now, without further ado, to present Game of the Year, it's my honor to introduce Christopher Nolan. Hey, Chris.
Thank
you, Jeff.
Nolan.
It's an honor
just
to be part
when.
Of the Game Awards.
Yeah.
For me, I've always been interested in telling stories that immerse the audience. I like movies that unfold in unexpected ways and pull people into a world. When I look at video games, I see a lot of parallels with that kind of storytelling. How
Mass
players,
Effect
agency, and choice intersect with more traditional storytelling
methods.
They already
methods. Said that.
It seems
exciting
dead
to see.
In the ground.
And
said that like 3 or 4 times.
Oh,
tonight,
my gosh.
All 6 nominees for Game of the Year are true masterworks in immersive storytelling. To pay tribute to them, please welcome from Abbey Road Studios the London Philharmonic Orchestra, conducted by my old friend Lorne Balfe.
Christopher Nolan called Fantasy 7 Remake on Masterworks.
I know. I didn't know he played it. What if he did?
What if he did, dude? Taking a cool 50 hours out of making Tenet is too.
I bet he skipped a lot of side quests, though. I just feel it. I don't know why.
Do they have a synth mixed in there? It's a cool medley.
Yeah, they did it that big too.
I mean, the
I'm
music is
music
Animal
these.
Crossing.
What is this transition?
I guess that's how they do it.
Yeah, I guess now that they're doing the guitar kind of transition.
Oh man.
Got kind of Doom vibes too. Yeah, that I really.
The Hades soundtrack is so good.
I don't need to see that phone.
Yeah!
It's so epic!
Yeah,
no, this is awesome!
Animal Crossing coming to the win.
Dude, I'm like emotional.
Tomorrow. Like, there's not a better way to present it. Game of the Year.
Yeah, man. Dude. Shit.
Well, that sounded fantastic.
That Animal Crossing got me teared up.
The Game of the Year award goes to The Last of Us Part 2.
Yep, knew it.
No surprise there.
Wow.
I
actually did think that there was a chance that it could go to something else.
Again, big congrats to all the other games we're nominated with. Everyone at Naughty Dog, I can't wait to hug and high-five and get drunk with each one of you. That's going to have to wait till next year. I want to just thank every person that worked on this Ambition game within Naughty Dog and outside. Shout-out to our Sony partners again, Scott Rohde, Connie Booth, Herman Pulse, Sean Layden, Jim Ryan, your support and trust in us means the world. And more than anything, and I know that I speak for the whole team when I say this, we'd like to thank our friends and family that stood by us and support us throughout us making this game. You inspire us not only to make better, more meaningful games, but to improve how we make games. On behalf of everyone at Naughty Dog, thank you.
Congratulations to Naughty Dog, Game of the Year for The Last of Us Part 2. And congratulations to all our winners and all the nominees around the world. Thank you for joining us virtually. And next year, hopefully, we will all be back together in person. But in the meantime, there'll be plenty of games to play. Congratulations also to Pluful, who is voted by the fans as their favorite emerging Valorant streamer. Let's all go raid her stream right now on Twitch. There's also the Twitch Gaming post show that's coming up right now Twitch Gaming. I'll be joining them to chat about all the things you liked and you didn't like in tonight's show. It's been a very unique year, but one thing that never changes is our passion for gaming and the games we love. Thanks to our Game Awards team and all the incredible developers and publishers around the world who made this show possible under very trying circumstances. I can't believe we did it. Take care, stay safe, happy holidays, and be well. I'm Jeff Keighley. Good night. We'll see you next year.
Thanks, Jeff. I'm seriously concerned for Elden Ring. Like, what's happening?
You already missed the boat on Elden Ring.
Don't forget,
it's
got Gurren attached to it.
Oh, right. That means it's never coming out.
He's telling the Elden Ring team that he's working on Book 6. He's telling the Book 6 team he's working on Elden Ring.
Right.
He's gaming in system right now.
What's he telling HBO?
All right. You guys can go at it. I'm going to start popping a couple. I got to pop a couple
strong,
things over to the YouTube channel.
Started strong and then a lot of commercials.
Yeah.
I mean, Sephiroth hype
the momentum.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I definitely felt the enthusiasm draining out of me as time.
Yeah,
for sure.
Yeah,
for sure.
I feel like Sephiroth or Perfect Dark should have been held for.
Yeah,
that was weird the way that they stacked
totally
announced
the
announcements.
Yeah.
Perfect Dark would have been way better than Mass Effect at the end.
I'm sorry. I just peeked over to Twitter, and there's a lot of people freaking out about Mass Effect. But it's like, what? What?
Right. Like, what is I don't know what that that wasn't an announcement. Like, I don't
it's
know
classic
what that is.
BioWare nonsense. Yeah. That shit won't come out forever. Like, they did the same thing with Dragon Age. It was like, ugh.
I think it helps, though, to build even more hype for the remasters coming out.
I was expecting them to drop.
How did they show the remasters?
I expected them to drop the remasters after that, because that would have made it hype.
Take a little
Have they said when those remasters are coming out?
I think
it was like summer, maybe, of next year.
They have. It's not that long from now, but yeah. I don't remember it.
Okay.
Yeah, because we knew a new Mass Effect was coming. So yeah, I get that. Of just like that was Did kind we? Of a non.
When
they've said it in a few.
AC
letters
left
things,
BioWare. Yeah. He said, "I'm looking forward to the future of Mass Effect." He's like, "They're going to do a great job with the rest of Mass Effect." Yeah. It's like he's like, "We already announced the remastered, but you know, we'll see." And like that's all that video did for me. Admittedly, I haven't played those games, so like I don't know like what the, you know.
One and two
characters
really
returning
good.
If she was not in Andromeda, if that's like the big twist.
Yeah.
Is that like
that was my wife in those games.
It's just such a strange, yeah. It kind of reminds me of the Breath of the Wild, you know, too, where it was like I was excited, but it was weird to have a trailer say like we're doing it, and I was like, that's what? That's a weird vibe from a trailer.
But Breath of the Wild,
we're in the studio right now.
A game that's in development.
Oh,
like
yeah.
This is just
Antiste,
generalized
like,
specific, yeah. Mass Effect stuff. Like, I don't know.
And it like had a weird intro with the you know going through like old recordings and stuff and. Was like
yeah, that was
how was that significant
well, was,
to the story?
That was all part of the Mass Effect lore. Like that's how I, you know.
But
like,
how is that
a
part
so
of Mass Effect 5? Like how does that? Now that you showed me that, what does that mean? Like what,
time? It's the same. Didn't what movie did that? Contact or something?
Contact. Yeah.
Yeah, where it's going backwards through time.
I'm good to go.
Man, as someone who loved those original three games. To different degrees. That was a hard thing to get excited about.
All the best to the team, though. Shout out to Evil Dead the Game and
Evil Dead the Game, man.
And some of the Callisto Protocol. I got high hopes for. Fingers crossed. 2020.
Yeah,
yeah, that is really a good one.
And of course, Dark Tide.
Mm-hmm.
Dark Tide is going to be a blast.
Yep.
I'm worried that Evil Dead the Game is going to be terrible, but I'll enjoy it anyway.
Yep.
Which is fine.
Like Friday the 13th.
Like Friday
you know?
The 13th,
like,
dude.
Which is totally fine. Yep.
Terrible
yep.
but amazing.
Yep.
How about the... What was the game that we thought was PT?
Returnal.
Housemark.
Okay, so Returnal, the name popped in my head, and I'm like, that's a silly name. Is that right? Oh, no, it is Returnal. Okay.
Like Returnal looks cool, but
yeah,
they did themselves a big disservice by making us all think for just a second that Silent Hill was involved.
Yeah, what the heck?
Bad decision.
Yeah.
There's just some things you put together, and one of those is the PlayStation logo and a hallway with a door at the end of it.
And with that graphical
with that exact lighting, and that graphical
style.
I'm sure the team is like, that's our game. I don't have to tell you. It's like you just have to know. But we got lots of fun looks at, it's funny, like stuff like, you know, seeing season three of Fall Guys is, it's kind of like Fast and Furious. It's like, I think Keeley was more excited than maybe even like the Fall Guys devs, and like showing stuff like that off.
Master Chief
in
some Walking Dead characters as well.
Yeah.
So wait, I know no one was talking about Fortnite, but what do we think a Nintendo character will join soon?
That'd
do we
be
really? Because it's all about hunters, so it's got to be Samus, right? And then because Metroid's coming out one day.
Well, it could make
I think
one day.
So perfect. One day. Yeah.
I mean, we recently talked about it came up again, and was it May earlier this year? They found references in Fortnite to these like extra characters from other systems, and Nintendo was one of them. So. Probably means there's a Nintendo exclusive character coming. I mean, you have a Xbox
Samus.
Icon, you got a PlayStation icon.
Yeah, that would be awesome.
Yeah.
Is Samus the most synonymous with being a hunter? I guess Turok, somebody said.
Yeah, Turok.
But Turok's not
just
Nintendo
Nintendo.
Exclusive, though. Yeah.
Yeah, it's not.
Yeah.
Yeah. Samus. I mean,
Samus
is a bounty hunter.
She's a bounty hunter.
Got it.
It's not exactly what I think of when I think of hunter, but yeah.
Yeah. I mean. Yeah.
Sephiroth, though. Like,
Sephiroth.
Smash isn't even my cup of tea, and I was hype as hell about that.
What they did with the Fake Mario killing was amazing.
Oh my god.
Incredible. Favorite part of the night.
Let him doing the Aerith stab by Zelda was really good.
Immediately making it my desktop the Aerith background. Stab.
Mario impaled.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, that's a GIF reaction I want to use for like everything.
Man, I definitely would have maybe put that
later. Yeah.
Yeah, that like
It helped in the beginning though, Ben.
It did help in the beginning.
It got us.
But yeah. I think it set an unrealistic expectation, especially with all these rumors. And I mean, obviously there are always going to be crazy rumors before the Game Awards, but it definitely, like, we're like, Sephiroth said, Elden Ring for sure, Silent Hill for sure, you know?
Like, I think the Vin Diesel arc thing was perfect at the beginning, because that, that could set, it was fun to react to, and then maybe you save Sephiroth for later, I don't know.
Yeah, and my only question is, when are we hopping into arc one?
I don't know, there...
I feel like I'm missing out, man.
I streamed it on our GT PC, it did not run it well when that first launched.
Yeah.
And that's always been something that I thought I would really enjoy if I, you know, just, you know, had the gumption to make it like the game I played. But
right after we hop into Warframe,
because you probably don't play as Vin, right? Or maybe you do. Like, it's just a bunch of Vins running around because it's a multiplayer game, and so it's like, is he like?
I kind
of
hope
more of a story focus if they're going to have
the head of the tribe.
Yeah. After that presentation, I'm ready to bring Ark to Hall of Greats without having played it.
Good pitch. Yeah, I got to put a podcast together with this. My brain is fried. I'm kind of like staring at this huge list.
We're shooting a podcast tonight.
Timestamps are going to
For those who are looking for more in-depth discussion, that will be happening. You're recording tonight.
I think Healy's head, too, was in the right place. I know we were kind of disappointed with Mass Effect at the end, but last year the finale was the Fast and the Furious game. Everyone really did not like that. So, I mean, on paper, it's like, okay, end with the return of Mass Effect. Like, that's worthy of being the end.
And he probably doesn't know, even though he should, because it's BioWare, like, how lame of a trailer it's going to be, you know? Like, you think it's going to be good. Damiani was trying to
same thing for Dragon Age.
End the stream, I think.
Oh no, I thought Jones wanted. I thought that was a cue from Jones, like let's go. I was like, all right, well, you know.
I don't want to go blow by blow through all this stuff.
Yeah, because you're gonna be doing it on the podcast.
We're about to do it. Yeah,
you're gonna record that tonight. When will that be going up for everyone? Remind everyone.
That'll be up tomorrow. Early access for everybody, but public on Sunday.
Nice. Yeah. Good timing.
Yeah. Check out patreon.com/smashbrothers
and
Easy Allies. Thank you to our mods. Big thank you to our mods. These events are tough on them. Mm-hmm. So thanks. Shout out to them. Thank you so much.
All right. Anything else before we check out here? Are we good to go? Another year of the Game Awards 2020 almost over? Yeah. Let's look forward to next year. Yeah.
Swedish Chef. Yeah. Still feels like we're just getting started on next gen, you know? Like we didn't see the fruits of next gen yet.
True.
Maybe E3 will start seeing those next gen games.
Skyrim's coming to Game Pass, so.
Well, thank all of you for joining us for this reactions, and we'll see you again next time. Bye, everyone.